And a very good afternoon to you. Welcome to round 21 SANFL IGA League action. We're here at Peter Motley Oval, home of the Double Blues, where the home side's taking on the Roosters in our game of the day on a Super Sunday of SANFL IGA League action. If you're having your Sunday roast, well, hopefully you've left room for a feast of football this afternoon. As you join us here, not only for the live coverage, we're bringing you the vision and the audio this afternoon. You can see the Double Blues running out onto the ground, led by Zane Kirkwood. They're chasing a consolidation spot in the top three this afternoon. North Adelaide, on the other hand, their final appearance in 2016. They'll be hoping to finish on a big note. So a lot at stake here this afternoon. We'll have all the action for you very shortly from the opening bounce. We saw a great reserves contest just finish a few moments ago, where North Adelaide held on 10-15-75 to defeat the Double Blues 9-8-62, a 13-point win to the visitors. So good news for the Roosters in the reserves competition. They consolidate their fourth place and they will play in September. The Double Blues, on the other hand, in the reserves, well, they'll finish up bottom of the ladder. It's a different story in the league action, with the Double Blues side sitting third at the moment, as we said, looking to consolidate a top three position on the ladder. They were at the top of the ladder for a number of weeks after they won 10 games in succession. They dropped their first game of the season, but they bounced back with 10 consecutive wins. A run which was only broken by the Adelaide Crows back in round 15. Since then, the Double Blues are 2-2 and they sit in third place. Ahead of them, the Eagles also playing today, and South Adelaide, who have the bye. So a critical match here for the Double Blues. Some big changes for them, looking to bring some speed back into the side here for the confines of Unley Oval. Peter Motley Oval, which is looking resplendent with the perimeter and its picket fence. And the team's going through their Adelaide to the southern end of Peter Motley Oval, just going through their warm-up, and Sturt to the north end, or the end closer to the Harry J. Mackay stand. We're up here high in the Jack Odie stand, bringing you all the action. Don Cooper with you this afternoon. I'll have your call for you. As we said, bringing you all the action live on your website, www.sanfl.com.au. And also thanks to our good friends who helped bring us to air at the Flight Centre. If you're a SANFL member, you can take your membership into any one of their centres around South Australia, or you can give them a call on 131 600, make a time to go in there, and they'll take $100 off your next travel costs. So good benefit there to be a SANFL member. It's a great benefit if you're a Sturt or North member and you're out here today, because we have picture-perfect conditions for you. You wouldn't want to be anywhere else. You can almost smell September in the air. The Sturt Footy Club, they're doing it nicely today on the eastern side and the southeastern pocket over there by the elm trees. They have a scene at Sturt Day going on, a great food and wine affair. So people over there enjoying some wonderful culinary delights, lubricating the tonsils and enjoying a good game of footy already in the reserves, and about to enjoy a fantastic game here in the league action. Some big ins for North Adelaide as well. Jay Shannon comes back into the side. Cohen Tierley back into the side for the Roosters today. They want to add a little bit of depth, a little bit of experience to their outfit. And there's some key ins as well as Michael Virgin. And he'll bring some real speed. We know that Michael Virgin, he loves to get the ball and go. He's a real hard nut. And that's something that North Adelaide will need. Looking at North Adelaide's season, well, they got an absolute thumping at the hands of the Bulldogs in round one to the tune of 107 points. In the next round, they bounce back and they beat Norwood by 57 points. So they already showed that they're a resilient side by round two. They've hung in there, only four wins for the season. They've all come against sides in the bottom four on the competition ladder as it stands at the moment. Sturt, on the other hand, with their 12 wins and four losses, those four losses only coming against sides in the top four. So there is a little bit of a class difference between these two sides here this afternoon, and I can see the Double Blues probably have the edge on paper, but footy's a funny game. The conditions out on the ground, well, it looks pretty good from up here in the Jack Odie stand, but I can tell you at ground level, it's quite soft underfoot, particularly out on the southeastern side around the 50 metre mark. So it'll be interesting to see how the teams attack their approach to goal. A fairly stiff and swirly breeze. You can probably hear it blowing through the mics at the moment. But it's probably one of those wins that we're going to just have to see how it plays out in the opening couple of quarters to see what sort of effect it might have. Swirling around, blowing all across the ground, but as we said, the side's going through their paces at the moment. The umpires are out there in readiness as well. We'll go through those for you this afternoon. The men in green, Andrew Crosby, Aaron Bennett, Giles Lewis in the field. Running the boundary here this afternoon, the quartet of Sam Royans, Hayden Cook, Tom Kelly and Matty Zaka. And in the goals, waving the calico, Stephen Ripp and Matthew Norton. So good luck to those gentlemen there this afternoon as well. And this critical round 21 match, critical for both sides, as we said, North Adelaide wanting to finish the season on a real high. Josh Carr, you'd have to think he'd be fairly happy with the outcome of the season, not just for wins and losses, but the endeavour the footy club has shown, and I think the respect that they've got back in the SANFL competition in 2016, a lot is due to his tenure there at the Roosters. So hopefully good things lie ahead of them in 2017 and they finish off well here this afternoon. Not a happy hunting ground for the Roosters though. They last won here in round 7 in 2012. So, well, we've been watching the Olympics over the last couple of weeks and it's been more than an Olympiad since they've tasted success here at Peter Motley Oval. The Double Blues, of course, a very happy hunting ground for them. Coach Marty Mattner will be very happy with how his troops have travelled through 2016. To date, of course, the depth being tested. We said that their reserve side finished bottom of the ladder, so it's a real test here for some of these youngsters coming in. We're just waiting on final confirmations of the side this afternoon to see if young Lewis Young, a young forward coming up from the Macca's Cup side, and I can confirm he is out on the ground. So Lewis Young, wearing the number 52 jumper, will make his appearance this afternoon for the Double Blues. His debut SANFL IGA League appearance at 17 years of age, standing 197 centimetres, weighing in at 91 kilos. He'll get a little bit of a taste of a league football action this afternoon. So all the best to him. I'm sure he's got a great band of family and friends following his fortunes this afternoon. And if they're not here, they're probably tuning in to the live stream action on www.sanfl.com.au. We thank the SANFL for letting us bring this to you as Zane Kirkwood and Mitch Clisby come into the 10-metre circle to toss the coin to see which way the sides will break to in the opening stanza here as the coin goes skyward. And the result is a Zane Kirkwood win. He's going to elect to take Sturt to the southern end of the tennis court or bowling green end of Peter Motley Oval in the opening quarter. So probably just aided perhaps by a little bit of a breeze. As I said, it's a swirling type of breeze. The flags right adjacent to the bowling green just fluttering and twirling around there. But no real advantage until we get to have a look and see how the sides attack it this afternoon. So very interested to see how this one plays out, the Double Blues. As we said, they're very keen to get a win. They still hold a faint hope they could finish minor premiers, but it will remain on the results of other games going on. And also, of course, that last match, the last minor round match, round 22, where South Adelaide then come back into play. And a very, very important match indeed for those in the context of the finals and how it will be set up. And of course, that game is South Adelaide taking on Adelaide at Hickenbotham Oval and the Double Blues hosting the Tigers at Peter Motley Oval. But that's another week away. We're right here with you this afternoon, a super Sunday of SANFL IGA League action. Other games going on around in the competition at the moment. Presently up at the Berry Oval, it's the Bloods taking on the Crows, and it's Adelaide 13-7-85 leading the Bloods 5-1-31, and that's deep into the second quarter there, so that game already underway. Other games for you this afternoon will keep you up to date. The Eagles and Glenelg at Mourne Team Hyundai Oval. Of course, top of the ladder there, the Eagles and Port Adelaide taking on Norwood down at Alberton. Some fierce rivalry there. Well, we're almost getting set for action here in our match of the day. The Double Blues and the Roosters. It's almost game time. The sides making their way to their positions. You can hear the preliminary sirens in the background. And we're almost in readiness for things to get underway here. The umpire stands prepared. Aaron Bennett with the burley in hand. About to get us underway. Big Andre the Giant in the 10-metre circle up against one of the best in the business, James Craig, sporting the big beard. And Perella about to go up against him. So we're almost set. Round 21 action. About to get underway. Here we go. Peter Motley Oval, the Double Blues and the Roosters. Perella. Circling up, Craig got the tap down. Shannon just overran it. Ball spills out, but the big fella did well. Perella got it out to Page, and Sturt go forward very quickly. Greenslade clever, got it to Young. First touch in league football. Wobbling ball, Grove did well. Got there first and got the Roosters out of trouble. Falls the way of Patterson, and he got his clearing kick away to right half back. And a good spoil by Page. Sends it out the back. Perella is just wrapped, wrestled to the ground. And we'll have a boundary throw in as the white paint won out on the eastern side of Peter Motley Oval. Good start by Sturt. As James Craig and Perella. The latter gets the front spot. Read it nicely. Took it out the ruck. He could be gone. The umpire said he was holding the ball. Didn't dispose of it correctly, and now a chance through Tahana for the Roosters. So they go into attack for the first time, and it's a good lead-up mark taken by Harvey. The former Magpie takes one step, goes bang inside 50. Big flight the back from Ryswick. Read now by Motlop, decided to back pedal, just headed off to Greg off one step, but McMahon reading it and safely over the boundary line. So the opening score of the day goes to the Roosters off the boot of Josh Gregg. Minor score, North Adelaide one behind, leading the Double Blues yet to score. So a good start there for the Roosters. Promising, attacking, and the Double Blues now rappelling from defence as Slimming sits underneath the kick that came out. He played on quickly, corralled by Barnes. Needed to get the hands free, and he did it well to Stevens, who sees the lead of Beard. Right in front of the interchange benches. Short little kick. Put Penfold under. Plenty of pressure. And he took a courageous little mark, Jack. Penfold quick to go on. Beard. Well, he gave the give and go. What will he do here? He decides I'll go to the hot spot. He's got Hanson there. Grove backing back. Roosters getting back in numbers. Oh, Hanson read it. Little toe poke. Minor score. Score's locked away then. With the Hanson's little kick. Just scurried through. He was under plenty of pressure. North Adelaide doing well defensively. So Spinner. Oh, it's a scrubby little kick. It's going to be intercepted by Kirkwood from 25 metres. He says you can have that back with interest. Pumps the air. And the Double Blues score their first goal. The first major of the afternoon. Sturt 117. North Adelaide one behind. 2.5 gone. Opening quarter. Well, I'm sure Alex Spinner would like to have that kick back as the Double Blues take the lead of Zane Kirkwood. He just read it. It was straight down the middle of the ground. It couldn't have been wrapped up any better for him if it was a Christmas present. And Zane Kirkwood just drilled it straight back through the middle. So opening goal to him, opening goal to the Double Blues. 6-point margin to the home side. Back in the middle. Beautiful bounce too. Sits high. Craig gets the tap down. Battersby in there for the Double Blues. Who's harassing. Circling. Players wanting it. McKenzie in there wearing the helmet there. Just circling. No clear winner. And Schwartz in there for the Roosters as well. Comes up. So secondary stoppage. Perella, Craig again. Won it out. Shannon in there. Quick to lock up Kirkwood. The umpire says we'll have to have another go. So he just can't extricate it out the 10-metre circle at the moment. So third man up, Schwartz decides, let's get it out of here. Motlop just took it off the fingertips of Tahana. They're linking up nicely now. Wilkie, beautiful left foot kick normally. Barnes was good, had a little toe poke off the ground. He needs support, and it comes down the form of Maxi Thring. Got it out the back to Barnes, and off one step. Roosters inside 50 again. Harvey, the big fly, picked up by McKenzie, spat it out the back to Shannon. Kick over the body. Well, it's into open space, but Slimming for Sturt did well, and he gets support now in the form of Martin, who just blazes away into open space. If it sits for Penfold, he's on, but it's not, and it's over the boundary line, and it will be a free kick. Wyatt Patterson not realising it was last disposal out of bounds. The last game of the season. The young man probably still getting used to the rule. So he plays on back through the corridor. Dangerous because it's cut off by Crocker. He's got numbers running. Kirkwood the first to call for it. He wants to send traffic further. Off the left shoe. Kick looking for and finds Hansen. Stretching high. Taking a good mark out in front of Tahana. And Benny Hansen. Distance will not be a problem. One of the best strikers at the Burley in the business. And he's back in the side today, Ben Hansen. He's kicked 73 goals in his 67 league appearances before today. And he struts in, crosses the paint of the centre square from 55. It's a thumping kick. It's a Ben Hansen special. And they get around him. Sturt get their second. They go to 2-1-13. North Adelaide one behind. Margin out to 12. And Ben Hansen, well, that's just his bread and butter. Struck it sweetly straight over the goal umpire's hat. So quick goals there to the Double Blues. 5.5 gone in our opening quarter here. And Sturt have a 12-point lead. So North Adelaide, they need to stand up. They've had the ball inside 50 a couple of times. Unable to hit the scoreboard with goals. Perella jumped early, went straight into his opposition ruckman, but the ball spits out the back here for Georgie Thring. So GT just flips it out the back there, got support. The left foot kick goes to the wing. Good defence there by the Double Blues from Guilfoy. Good pressure coming from the Roosters. And now Battersby just goes back, gives it to Guilfoy, and the kick's good, and it finds Greenslade at full stretch. He's got Hansen on his own. He can't get it there, so he's got to load up to the young fella in Young, who had back position there. Did well at the back there with the Roosters. Tahana now looked one way, then decided to go through the middle. Dangerous again. Is it deja vu? Kirkwood flipped it out the back. Here's a chance now for Leanett, who is a thumping kick, and he's hit it post high into the woodwork for a minor score. Well, it almost came undone again for North Adelaide. They're taking too many risks by foot. They're not renowned as a good kicking side at the best of times. They've just got to find a way to work it out of defence better, and that's a lot better choice because it goes to Grove. Whistle gone. A free kick going to Perella. Perella goes back to Harms, who just loads up back in the side again today. Beard had position A, couldn't get purchase on it. Comes to ground level. Georgie Thring's there for the Roosters, trying to scrap and scrag. Did well out the back there. Now to Spinner, who just looped the hand pass over the top to Grove, combining with McKenzie. Oh, it's slippery out there. Grove nearly went down. A couple of Sturt players, well, they got evaded by Tahana, who just went bang with a thumping kick, and it's a beauty to Ryswick. Ryswick now, defensive side of centre wing. He needs a lead up, but it's an intercept pass going the way of Page with the turnover. Goes inboard to Battersby. Wanted to show a little bit of the leather. Goes back to Page, who goes laterally to Stevens at half back. Now Stevens just goes short and finds Battersby inside the centre square. Driving kick to Greenslade in open space. He can go here. He takes a bounce, lifts the eyes, sees the white sticks, loads up, lines up and drills it. Champagne football, Sturt. Johnny Greenslade on the end of that one. He becomes their third goal scorer. They're just about looking like they're starting to line up now, the Double Blues. They could raffle it at the moment. 8.25 minutes gone. It's out to a 19-point lead with the Double Blues 3-2-20, leading North Adelaide one behind. So just beautiful intercept work there. It all started at the back. Guy Page with the intercept mark. And again, just errors by foot from the Roosters with the turnover. And that's going to hurt them all day long. Back in the middle, that is a beautiful bounce. Craig got the fingertips on it. De Leonardis is in there. Couldn't get hands on it. Kick spits out the back here. Chance now for the Roosters if they're first there with Clisby, who gave off the don't argue. He says, I've got to show something here. I'm the skipper. So he bangs it inside 50. Good punch at the back. Ryswick couldn't take the mark. Guilfoy good with his look-away hand pass. And Slimming here, he's just hovering on right half back. He's been there all day and he's picking up his disposals, and that's a beautiful kick to Mark Evans. So Evans on true centre wing, just in front of the Mackay stand. He's looking inboard. He decides to hugged the line, the right half forward. Beard sets himself. Craig was good at the front and probably get the free kick too. Advantage not paid as Swartz was away. Georgie Thring and Johnny Green's laid down there just having a little chat as Craig goes with a nice little spot-up pass to Spinner at left half-back. So Spinner now, this is the kick they're falling down on. So he decides to look for a big target in Harvey, and he presents and he takes the mark. He's got to go. He nearly went off his line. The umpire gave him the benefit of the doubt. So now he squares it up inside the 10-metre circle. He had Swartz in there. Now with the running Greg off the left boot. That's a better kick. It lines up and finds McKenzie, who was out in front of Josh Hone. McKenzie, the way he's looking, he's not confident with the distance here. He's looking for a lead. And he goes short, and he's got Motlop in the pocket. So hasn't really gained any ground in distance, and that's a tough little kick from there at the best of times. If anyone could pull it off, Marlon Motlop could with a little bit of his magic. But he probably should have had a better lead up from Harvey or Barnes, one of those two big targets who still may come into play depending on what Motlop chooses to do. He sets it up into the teeth of the breeze. It gives the big men a chance to fly at the back. Good defensive work by the double blues. Harms now links up with Kirkwood, who goes short to Greenslade. Greenslade now, still in his defensive 50, goes short with the lead up kick and finds Jonas, who squares it to the outer side looking for Page. The wind just took that one, so Page provides the shepherd for McMahon to go by hand. Receives it now, a little bit of candy from Page, and he backpedaled and goes back. With a kick now across the face of goal from Guilfoyt. See Stevens take it on the burst, goes with a long looping hand pass. Kick coming back inboard now, lean it, tackled beautifully by Spinner. Ball came out in the tackle, the umpire said, and eventually he'll throw it up as umpire Bennett comes in. Good work there from Cohen Tierley, what could be his last game in a Roosters jumper. So over the top, third man up, tap away by Grove, clearing the hands now and racing away. Here is Hone. He looks up after a bounce. He goes over the top to Beard. He's got Hanson calling for it, but he went square. Kirkwood worked his opponent underneath the ball there. That was Spinner. Got the hand pass out the back here. They're struggling now at the moment. Greg did well. Hanson tries that little scrubby kick. It bounces favourably for Grove, though, and he gets support. And the Roosters will get out of trouble, but momentarily. As Tierley takes it, goes across on the 45, and this time it comes off to Spinner through the corridor. The switch is onto the outer side to Maxi Thring. So Thring now runs away. Kick is good, and it spots up and finds Ryswick. But now they've got no numbers up forward, so Ryswick has to square with the lateral kick and find Sam DeLeonardis. So SDL just gives it off to McDonough. Under pressure, got a little kick away. The umpire said that's okay. Ryswick now, hand pass finds Barnes. Turns one way, looked up, lead was good. Kick was good, mark was great. And Harvey takes it on the chest. Much better work by the Roosters. And Mitch Harvey has a chance to get North Adelaide's first major of the afternoon on the board. Ticking towards the 13-minute mark. Harvey. He's played every game in the Roosters jumper this season. He's one of 10 who has. And this would be a great start for him, a good confidence booster. The career goal number 80, if he can slot it. It's a nice looking kick, but it's just gone to the wrong side. So the minor score, that margin reduced to 18 now. The game high was 19. With that behind from Mitch Harvey. The double blues holding a nice advantage at the moment. Lean it to himself, feigned one way and then brought it to the grandstand of your broadcast side with a 65-metre drop punt. Thank you very much. At the back, Young couldn't take it. Spills free. In there's Carey. Had to spin around. Got a hand pass out to Greenslade. Under good pressure. Swartz is there for the Roosters. Good tackle. But it came out the back. Left foot was from Penfold. High, high ball, but great courage and a good mark taken by Georgie Thring. So Thring squares it up and finds Patterson. Defensive 50. Nice kick. Finds Maxi Thring. So Patterson in the middle of a couple of Thrings there. What can Maxi do? Chipping ball. Ryswick on the lead. Pretty happy to present up the ground at the moment, Lee Ryswick. That is a terrible kick inside his forward 50 and it's chipped off by Martin. But Martin squares it up to Stevens at true halfback. A bouncing hand pass. Well, he's put his teammate under pressure here. But he did well to get it back. Now Stevens at second attempt decides I'll go by foot and the kick's good. So they're away here now through Harms. Harms with a searching kick and it was centimetre perfect to Mark Evans. Probably a little bit too far out to score. He's in the green sloppy grass out there. Hard to get purchase on it. And the kick was a poor one anyways. Patterson floated across and made sure it was thumped out of bounds. Almost in front of the scene at Sturt crowd over there. A good crowd enjoying the afternoon. Some food, some wine, some fantastic football. Doesn't get much better than that on a Sunday afternoon. And you're tuning into the live stream coverage. Thanks to the SANFL. Round 21 action. Boundary umpire. About to catapult the ball back into play. Beard wrestling Barnes. Third man up over the top was Evans. It came to Beard with a one-step kick around the shoulder, but a minor score. So they've squared up the ledger. Three of each. 3-3, 21 the Double Blues. North Adelaide, two behinds. So again, it's a 19-point margin. Ball now goes to the outer side and Tahana with a nice kick. Finds Jay Shannon at right half-back. Right in front of the parochial Double Blue crowd over there. Shannon's kick holding up in the breeze, but it held up nice with Barnes. He just put the big dukes up. Gave it off to McDonough, who scurried through some scrap traffic to McKenzie. And now McKenzie got it to Motlop, who just tucked it under the arm. Went for a bounce, went for a kick on goal. And Stevens will just safely see it roll through for a minor score. So they're peppering away. North Adelaide, here's a chance for Ryswick to chip one off, but he couldn't. Harms tackled, got rid of it. Good pressure from North Adelaide. That was good. Much better. Ryswick seeing the opportunity there to cut that one off. Just couldn't take the mark. So the ball over the boundary line. It'll be thrown back in. There's Young, the debutant. Flipped it out the back. Motlop couldn't quite grab it. Martin's in there for the Double Blues. And he just makes sure that the ball's not going anywhere as McDonough gets up. And hands the ball back to umpire Lewis, who says, we'll do it again. Young, third man up, Schwartz. They're doing that at the moment now. Spits out the back to Harms. He just slammed it on the boot. It was a kick in hope, really. It was well read by Wilkie, but the hand pass just a little bit too hot for Greg. So it forced a stalemate situation there, the contest. We'll have another ball up. Third man up again, Schwartz. Looks like that's his job today. Shannon in there for the Roosters. Just looking around, circling was Hone, but he couldn't get a look at it either. So we'll have another stoppage. Plenty of those happening today. The ball thrown high. Young with the tap down. Martin off one step. Little inside out, wobbler. Comes to right half forward, foot race now. Hanson did well for the Double Blues and Patterson did nicely too for the Roosters. Stalemate situation, boundary line wins out and we'll have a throw in. 17 and a half gone, opening quarter. You can see the vision right in front of us. Ball thrown back in. Worked underneath it was Perella. Ball at ground level. And looks like we'll have another stalemate. As the umpire comes in, circles and says, I better have it. So now Perella again, pushed out of it by Barnes. Barnes with a kick off the left foot. Will it sit for Harvey? He just couldn't take it. I think he might have been pretty happy with the result too, as Guilfoy made sure he and the ball went over the line. They're right between the interchange gates here. Peter Motley Oval. 18 and a quarter minutes gone of your opening quarter here. The Double Blues by 18. Perella tapped down. Motlop tried a little bit of magic. Didn't pay off. High tackle on Battersby and he'll be rewarded with the free kick. He wants to go on quickly, but Tierley coming off the bench there just thwarted that. Little pass to Martin. So Battersby now. Indecisive. Decides to backpedal to Leanit. Well, Leanit can go here. He should by foot, but he's worked himself into trouble. And that's just holding the ball as a textbook one that you would ever want to see. Marlon Motlop there. It's a couple of indecisive moments by the Double Blues. And Motlop's kick finds McKenzie. Quick to play on. Calling for it was Patterson, but he's decided to go the longer option and finds George Thring. So Thring takes it even wider to right half forward to Ryswick. Ryswick now inside 50. One on two situation. They've got to be good here. Chance for Maxi Thring off the left if he's good enough. Well, he is. He's good enough to get the kick, but the ball was spoiled away by Guilfoy. Sturt standing up defensively at the moment. Fourth behind for North Adelaide. They trail by 17. Sturt on 3-3, 21, 19 and a half gone. So the ball extricated from the Sturt cheer squad. Floggers down there. As Leanert goes with a thumping drop punt to the outer side. 1-2, taking the mark was Young. Nicely plays on. They're running the ball here beautifully with the breeze at the moment. Sturt, it sits for Evans. He can scurry away here. He took an ambitious bounce from one step from 48 metres. Well, there's nothing ambitious when you've got talent to match. Mark Evans, as confident as you like, took a bounce on the spongy turf, ran to 48 and just split the middle. His first of the afternoon. Sturt get their fourth. They're 4-3-27. North Adelaide, four behinds. It's a 23-point game high margin. Just ticked into time on. 20 and a half gone. It's all too easy. They're using that breeze nicely, the double blues. As we said, we're starting to find out about this breeze. It's swirling, but it's definitely favouring the southern end. Up high, Perella. Doing well against James Craig, one of the best in the business, the latter from North Adelaide. Ball now, chance here for Greenslade. He went by hand. Crocker had to shrug one tackle, then another. He got Battersby in support by hand, and now Kirkwood off one step, bangs it inside 50. This time Evans was outpointed by Tahana. Did well. Tierley in there to lend support. And McKenzie by hand, linking up through George Thring, and eventually Clisby decides to go off the boot and finds Motlop. And Motlop, a good mark. Out there in front of Carey, Motlop, that dangerous kick, looking back inboard to the corridor. They're under pressure here again now. Chance for Battersby, got it to Carey. Lovely, went one way, then the other. And off the left boot, decided I'll pass it into the goal square. And Mark Evans, you can have a shot at goal number two, which you will not miss. This will end up in Mitchum if he kicked it hard enough. And he slots it just into the back of the net. Second for Mark Evans, fifth for Sturt. Danger signs for North Adelaide. Again, just that dangerous kick from the Roosters going back in on the 45 to the corridor from the left half-back flank. I think Josh Carr might be saying to them at quarter time, boys, that's just not working. Well, it's working for Sturt, all right, because they've got about three goals out of the turnover. They're sitting on 5-3-33, 29-point margin. The game highs just keep stretching out with every goal. As umpire Bennett about to get us back in business. Nice bounce. Favours Craig though. Perella had a little look at it, but Craig thumped it forward. Picked up by Page. Combines with Battersby. McMahon decides to go with a little dribbler looking for Page. He read it well. Nice support from the back there through Stevens. Stevens' little give eventually results in the ball being thrown in. The guy Page being thrown over the boundary line by Cohen Tierley. And we'll have a throw in. So it's on the North Adelaide right half forward flank on the eastern side of Peter Motley Oval. So Perella forced to take the back position against Craig. He worked him under it nicely. But this is where they're having trouble, North Adelaide. They're good at the hit-outs, but just not in the clearances. And that's the trouble for them at the moment. They're just not getting first hands on the footy after James Craig's getting first hands on it. So there's some issues there. Here's a chance now. Can Clisby, around the body off one step, send them forward? He does. And almost sat for McMahon. SDL has another chance. De Leonardis in there on hands and knees under pressure from Guilfoy. Comes out the back. Motlop just lost his footing there, but did well to McKenzie, who now to Tierley off that beautiful left foot he's got. And he finds Jay Shannon in open space. So they worked it through there nicely, North Adelaide. They were just patient. They didn't panic. And eventually the ball lands in the hands of Jay Shannon, who will come in and have a shot on goal. It's only his 11th game this season, Jay Shannon. He's back into the side. Been an up and down year for him. He'd dearly love a goal. He's edging towards his 50th goal in league football. Let's see what he can do here. He strikes it nicely. Got right into it too, and he's got it through. North Adelaide get their first goal, Jay Shannon. His opener for the day. The North Adelaide 1-4-10, Sturt 5-3-33. back to a 23-point margin. Just ticked over 24 and a quarter minutes in the opening quarter. Well, that's a good confidence booster for Jay Shannon and a great confidence booster for North Adelaide. They wouldn't want to have gone to quarter time with a zero sitting in the majors. They're 1-4-10. We said that margin back to 23. And some good signs there as they just worked it through the Sturt defence, who have been terrific. And we're back in the middle. Perella, this time a little knockdown. De Leonardis in there, got a little kick away. McKenzie now, he's been great already. A nice kick around the body. And it finds Virgin. Another one returning to the side today. Michael Virgin loads up. He's got Harvey sitting underneath it. It almost put it on his head. It was a four-on-one situation. Stephen stripped of it, but he got it nicely away to Slimming, who goes with his left foot. Well, it's a pinpoint pass to Evans, who nearly took it on the second grab, but Spinner was excellent to force the issue over the boundary line. So Sturt just running that ball out of defence so quickly, catching North Adelaide out. Boundary throw in now. Craig tapped down. Schwartz, was he held? No. Got the hand pass away to Tahana. Greg now. Little inside out kick. He was looking for Maxi Thring. Harms did well to harass him. Slimming picked it up nicely. Got it to Page. Back in the 1-2. Slimming now crosses the turf of Peter Motley Oval to find Stevens, who didn't have to break stride. His kick was looking for Hanson, but it was read much better by Wilkie. He goes with a little chipping kick out to GT. So Thring of the George variety. Kick almost picked off by Stevens. Picked up in the soft turf. Got it to Crocker. Linking up here now. The kick from Guilfoy's good, and it finds his teammate leading up in Young. The youngster, 17-year-old, just loads it up. Beard at the back, caught out. Went for the punch instead of the mark. Picked up here now by Grove. Went back inboard by the hands. Greg now, that's dangerous because it's picked off by Hanson from almost an impossible angle. He sat it up, Motlop, courageously, eyes on the ball all day long, and took the chest mark in front of Beard, who came back, was never going to be in the contest and did the right thing. And Motlop took the good mark. His kick's good too, and finds De Leonardis just outside North Adelaide's defensive 50. So SDL, he's unsure. He says, I'll give it back to you, Marlon. You can rack up another stat. Just watch that kick inboard. And he elects to go to the boundary line this time. That's better because the big man Craig's there and he takes it on the chest. Read it beautifully. Craig now. McMahon front spot, but it won't matter as Maxi Thring comes crashing in to crash through the pack and put an end on the first quarter here at Peter Motley Oval. Round 21 action, the Double Blues and the Roosters. And at quarter time, it is Sturt 5-3-33. Leading the Roosters a 1-4-10 to 23-point margin. It got out as high as 29, but it's back to 23 now thanks to Jay Shannon's goal. We'll go through the goal scorers and then we'll have a look at some of the stats from the opening stanza here at Peter Motley Oval, and also check your scores around the grounds from other games this afternoon. For the Double Blues, their multiple goal scorer is Mark Evans. He has two, and singles to Greenslade, Hanson and Kirkwood. And for North Adelaide, it's Jay Shannon with their sole goal. So 5-3-33 leads 1-4-10, 23-point margin the end of the first quarter. Let's have a look at some of the major stats for you from the opening stanza. And on the on the overall disposals, fairly even there. Sturt leading the way there, 97-95. In the hit-out department, an interesting one there. James Craig's all over that one. North Adelaide lead that one 16-3. And as far as the hit-outs there, well, wouldn't be surprised to see all of those going to James Craig, but he's done a fantastic job there in the ruck. He's had the nine hit-outs. Of course, Schwartz going in third man up on occasions there. Clearances, though, 9-7 in favour of the Double Blues, and that's an area where they're very, very good at in the competition. They don't lead the ruck hit-outs at all, but they certainly are very high up in the clearances. A problem for North Adelaide at the moment with the Double Blues on bowlers having a field day at the moment. As far as inside 50s go, well, there's more to Sturt, but only just. 12-10, they lead that one. and a rebound 50s 9-7, and a lot of their goals have been rebounded out of North Adelaide's 50 zone. So the Sturt defence doing nicely there at the moment. As far as individual goal scorers, individual stats winners go, we've been through the goal scorers. James Battersby has 10. He's equal on the ground with 10 for Marlon Motlop. And then for the Double Blues, we have Stevens on 9, Kirkwood also on 8, Guilfoy, Greenslade, Page and Slimming on 7. For the Roosters, Jordan McKenzie has the 9 disposals. Corey Grove has 6. Josh Gregg, good to see him finding some form too, the 5 disposals. And a number of Roosters on the 5 disposals, including Lee Ricewick, Steve Dehana, Alex Barnes, Mitch Clisby, and Georgie Thring. So teams in their huddles, quarter time. Sure, Josh Carr will be trying to tweak the game plan coming out of defence for North Adelaide more than anything, because they gave away 3 goals, I would say, from memory in that opening quarter, where they tried to come back in from the left half back flank back through the corridor, and it was just picked off too easily by the Double Blues. And also Alex Spinner having a bit of a grubby kick that went straight to Zane Kirkwood, and he saw it go straight back over his head for a goal to open proceedings. So they're making a few mistakes at the moment, North Adelaide, but you can't question their endeavour. The Double Blues, on the other hand, just showing that little bit of class that we talked about before the game, and it is coming to fruition at the moment. Probably time for us to go around the grounds and have a look at some of the other scores in the SANFL Super Sunday of action. And up at the Berry Oval there, it is Adelaide just running a rampant 15-8-98. They lead West Adelaide 5-1-31 in the third quarter there. At Mourne Team Hyundai Oval in the first quarter, close to quarter time, the Eagles 4 straight, lead Glenelg 3-1. So a 5-point margin there to the league ladders. And down at Alberton Oval, well, it's a shocker for Norwood fans, because they are absolutely getting smoked by Port Adelaide at the moment. The Magpies 7-4-46, Norwood yet to bother the scorers. 46-point margin there to the Magpies. Wow, that's a big shock for Redlegs fans. Port Adelaide, well, maybe they do harbour some hopes to shake things up as far as this ladder goes. So certainly a big, big game for them down there, and they have responded accordingly, the Magpies. They currently sit in sixth position. They are just one game out of the 5 at the moment, I should say. Of course, Central District not playing this weekend with the bye. So given the percentage, that's going to be the thing. If they have a massive win there tonight, even though this is Port Adelaide's last game, they could knock the Doggies out of fifth position by the end of the night. So percentage will be the key there. We'll keep an eye closely on that game for you here. And that's all thanks to our good friends at the Flight Centre for that little fly around the grounds there. And if you can give them a call on 131 600, you can make sure you can pop into one of their centres all around the state, show your SANFL membership, and they'll take $100 off the cost of your next travel. So they're great people to deal with. We love the fact that they're involved in supporting the SANFL IGA League coverage, your live stream coverage coming to you this afternoon from Peter Motley Oval. Hope you're enjoying the call and the vision, the scenes here as the sides break from their huddles. Plenty of people out there. It's great to see local footy on a Sunday afternoon. The hill is packed to the left of our commentary position here. Good, good crowd here, and it's great to see the SANFL being supported. Great to see a lot of red and white too coming out to wish their league side all the best. They've got 3 quarters left of season 2016 ahead of them. Let's see what they can do. Only moments away from a restart. Second quarter action. It's the Double Blues by 23. They're just about all in readiness. Let's see what North Adelaide can do with the aid of this breeze. Umpire Lewis scanning the area, waiting for the all clear. He gets the okay from the goal umpire, so we'll be away. Here we go, Craig and Perella waiting for the bounce. Martin gone to McKenzie. Even tussle that between the two rucks. It came back in Perella's chest, so Craig locked him up, swung him around, and convinced the umpire we'll have another go at it. So ball thrown high, Perella this time locking arms literally with Craig. No real winner. Clisby comes in there. Harms is in there for the double blues, and it's like a Greco-Roman wrestling match at the moment. There's no clear winner. So the ref comes in. Craig this time tapped down. Harms got the arms free. Got it to Kirkwood with a little high up and under that's swirling and circling. It swirled too much for Evans. Couldn't take the mark. We got a beautiful shepherd from Martin to fly the hand pass out to Leanit. He went by hand to Battersby, and now Harms involved again. So good moments for Tommy Harms here. Back in the side. Kick inside 50. But it's cut off by Grove. So the Roosters now. Ball in hand. What can they do with it? They burn it too much from this situation in the opening stanza. Grove decides to go long with the aid of the breeze. Now here's a chance. Clisby on the end of it. Released Motlop, who just tripped over and unavoidably hand passed it out of bounds. But because it was a legal disposal, free kick to the double blues. Quick to play on. Lean it. Load it up. And comes across the ground to Crocker, who's held up. Has to be 25. So Maxi Thring giving away the professional 25 there. He's up in the face of Matty Crockett, but it doesn't matter because Crocker's got the ball. And he goes short to McMahon with a low pinpoint pass. McMahon just gives it to Hansen. Here's trouble. Loads up from 51, but he sees straight away it's got a bit of a slice on the kick and it's going to roll out of bounds. Touched off a couple of fingers there, namely from Martin and Motlop. But it wasn't, said the boundary umpire. So Brodie Martin, for all his convincing, it didn't work. So Motlop now has a chance to send North Adelaide out of the pressure zone. And he does with a lovely kick. Barnes just jostling for position. Read beautifully at the back by Schwartz. Kick off the left foot was good. Oh, Harvey just juggled it, but he kept it in front of him before he just cannoned into Kirkwood. So the ball releases out. Perella did well. Spotted up Leanit. Got the hands free at the back looking for Martin, but wrapped up in a good tackle. We'll have a boundary throw in. It's Cohen Tierley making sure Brodie Martin not going anywhere there. The ball thrown up. Third man up, tapped down. Clisby just hacked it out into open space. And the boundary line will win out again. We'll see how the umpire calls this one. And again, last disposal. So Page has a chance to use it now inboard to Guilfoyle, and he does. So Guilfoyle, that's right in the softest part of the ground there. So Guilfoyle squares it up to Stevens. This is where they're good, Sturt. They've got the switch on. They've got Jonas in open space. Oh, the kick was overcooked here. So there's a chance for McDonough to come in, force the issue. He did well. He needs support. It arrives in the form of Max Thring, but not before the kick's delivered to Kirkwood. Now Kirkwood, a searching pass, and it made Greenslade work to within a centimetre of the boundary line, and he took the mark. Got up, and his kick was good to Crocker. So Crocker now in front of the Mackay stand goes short to the shadows of McMahon, who was just lurking in them, and his low drilling kick has just hit Hansen right on the logo of the jumper. So again, they've managed to stretch the ground, stretch North Adelaide's defence and find an open player. So Benny Hansen, you know, he's such a beautiful striker of the ball. We've seen an example of that already. He would have learnt from that previous kick. He's got to start this to the left-hand goalpost from the pain of 50. Hansen loads up, and it's just holding its line. Didn't come back with the breeze, so minus score. That margin now, 24 points in favour of the double blues at the four-minute mark. Sturt 5-4, 34. North Adelaide 1-4, 10. Ball back in play. McKenzie forced to dive low and takes the mark. Good skills from one of the best players in the competition, Jordy McKenzie. Goes short and finds Patterson. Patterson just bangs it on the right boot. Good fly at the back there from Shannon. Couldn't take it though. Sturt working feverishly. Guilfoyle wrapped up by Harvey. The umpire comes in and says, 50-50 contest. Mitch Harvey seeing red a little bit. The big redhead. We're getting the jeers from the Sturt crowd here as Perella gets front spot. No clear winner. McKenzie through heavy traffic. Wrestled, held up. Harms in there. Good tackle. Ball up. Good hard football. Well umpired. As umpire Burke comes in, throws it high. Third man up, McKenzie. Harms read it well, although Crocker ran into McDonough. And he's wrapped up. And another ball up. McDonough not keen to release either the ball or Matty Crocker. Eventually, they part, and we'll have a throw up. Craig and Perella in a riveting contest. Harms, well, he's given away the free kick for blocking to McKenzie, who quickly gave it to Tahana. There's a nice little kick, actually. It was a short kick there by Motlop. Now Harvey. Harvey, inside 50. Barnes on the lead. Oh, he presented beautifully. The ball set for Maxi Thring. He feeds it out to Tierley. He loves this situation. The kick is high, wide, and not so handsome because it goes out of bounds on the full in front of McMahon, who will take the kick back in for Sturt. Well, he decides to go by hand and gives it to Leanit. Leanit keeps it low and pinpoint and perfect out to Josh Hone. Hone now, right half back flank. Nearly 6 minutes gone. The double blues by 24. Hone now squares it up again to McMahon. They've got Page further. So they've gone the switch again to the Odie side, the Odie grandstand side. Guilfoy has to be good. Was clever to Slimming. Nice tap over the back. Oh, Stevens just lifted the eyes because he saw the red and white jumper of Thring coming of Maxi. Page did well. Harms got the hand pass out. Slimming finding open space everywhere today. Kick into a two-on-one situation. Oh, nearly getting back to take the mark there was Beard, but North Adelaide standing up well. And here's a chance for Tahana. He's in a lot of trouble, but he got support there. And off the one step, they're out of trouble, North Adelaide, but only momentarily, as Kirkwood just sees it land in his chest. Goes short, he's got a couple of options here, and it's the big man, Andre the Giant, standing there all alone, taking the mark about 42 metres out, directly in front of goal, kicking towards the northern end. Well, North Adelaide, they're just being harassed and pressured at the moment. Clisby's kick off the one step, just falling in the hands of Kirkwood. And Kirkwood's kick to Perella was fantastic. Let's see what Andre can do. The kick's on its way. It's not going to make the distance. Big punch at the back. And minor score forced through. That was good work by big James Craig back there for the Roosters. So the double blues drift along 5-5-35. North Adelaide 1-4-10, 25-point margin. The Roosters. Now the ball in the hands of Wilkie, who goes for a short kick to Shannon. Shannon's kick, oh, was just over the top of Grove, so it was picked off here by Jonas, who got it to Hone. Hone's wobbler inside 50. It was well read by Spinner. Mark or free kick. And he did well, found front position. And Spinner holding strong, taking a good, strong contested mark in front of Beard. Called to play on now. So he goes long towards left half back. Ball folds at the back. Picked up by Martin. Had support by hand to Stevens. Stevens' hand pass, though, put his teammate under pressure. And the good tackle then. Shannon there arriving to make sure Slimming was going nowhere. The ball up. McKenzie, third man up to Clisby, who just said, let's get it out of here. A tumbler that went to Harvey on his chest. And he can go over the top here to Ryswick. He can run into the open goal. And Lee Ryswick drills home. North Adelaide second. Well, that's using the ball better. It's using the breeze better. And it's better football. So Lee Ryswick gets his first. North Adelaide their second. They're 2-4-16. That margin now back to 19 points. 8 3/4 gone. The double blues, 5-5-35. Ryswick gets his first goal in game number 199. So he falls just one game shy of his 200 with North Adelaide not proceeding any further in 2016. And that was goal number 192. They get nearly a goal a match out of that man. He's been one of the great stalwarts of the North Adelaide Football Club. Back in the middle, Perella, a little finger tipper. The clearing kick away now is into open space. Foot race here. Good work, good tackle. But no, the umpire said it was in the back. So the free kick goes to Carey. Carey now just dodges around the tackler, who was Wilkie. And he goes with a lovely kick to the lead up of Johnny Greenslade. So he's pushed himself in towards the pocket. It's a difficult kick, but he'll have the breeze probably right behind him from there. He steps back into the shadows, almost on the pickets here at Peter Motley Oval in front of the hill. And the hill will go crazy if he kicks this. Greenslade with a skip and a stutter. Kicks on its way. Fading, drifting across the face of goal. Spoiled away. And the boundary line will win out. So no addition to the scoreboard from the kick from Greenslade. And the throw-in results, about 20 metres around from the Double Blues goals. As the rucks set themselves, Beard going to do the duties against Craig. Craig again nearly got it out the back. Evans stripped of it. Good tackle. And that was by Tahana. And the ball's wrapped up in a couple of players there. And Sam DeLeonardis just kindly gives it back to the umpire, who throws it skyward again. Craig tapped down to McDonough. Tried to free the arms, but the tackle was good. Hone in there, just delivered the ball out. Here's a chance now for Kirkwood. Off one step, kick around the body. Defence was good by North Adelaide. DeLeonardis now links up, and he's got Patterson, who can tuck it under the arm. Links up with Motlop by hand. Oh, his look-away hand pass. Well, he should have looked probably. This time, that's better. Chance now here for North Adelaide. DeLeonardis shows some composure, goes short to Virgin. The Virgin now. They have to take a break, a breath, and reset here in North Adelaide. Virgin hugs the line, looking for Harvey. He had to do a lot of work. Oh, Clisby, clever to keep it in. The kick favours Ryswick. He's an absolute speedster. It's a foot race between him and Jonas. Great work by Jonas, because Ryswick was going to try something a little bit special there. He just didn't have the half a yard on Jonas. And the throw-in results. 10 metres around from North Adelaide's goal. Barnes sets himself against Young. Ball comes down, ground level. Lots of pressure there. Ball not coming out. We'll have a resultant ball up. Tierley. Wrap Page up. So a no contest there. Back to the rucks to do it. Young got a fingertipper. Red by Thring. Oh, that's a little bit of Maxi magic. Thring. And you reckon Max doesn't like that? Great goal, North Adelaide. Something out of nothing. It's what they needed, a little bit of spark. They're back in the game. That margin, now only 13 points. North Adelaide, 3-4-22. The Double Blues, 5-5-35. Just over 12 minutes gone in this second quarter. And that was a great goal to Maxi Thring. He just read it beautifully off the ball up. Off one step around the corner. And he liked the look of that as soon as he kicked it. The game on here, North Adelaide, working themselves back into the contest. Barnes into the ruck now. He goes up against Young. Young might have won it down. It comes ground level. McDonough's in there. And he's just making sure that Hone's not going anywhere at all. So we'll have a secondary stoppage. Still in the 10-metre circle. Ball thrown high. Young went right over the top, but Maxi, fresh off a goal, just gave it off to his brother George, whose kick around the body was hacked off the ground by Harvey into open space now, and it's picked up by Leanert. Leanert had a couple to get around, did it nicely, worked with Crocker, goes back to Jonas, and Jonas is kick smothered, and we'll have a ball in. And Crocker coming in just to say, hey, that's enough, boys. Getting a little bit heated out there. Physical encounter, of course, we said. North Adelaide's last appearance for 2016. Well, they're throwing it right up to one of the premiership contenders here today. And at the moment, it was out to 29 points. It's back to 13. Ball thrown in. Young did well. Battersby tried to get it to Crocker. Just managed to get a foot on it. Hone now linking up with Kirkwood, and they're out of trouble here now. The debutant Young with a driving kick that's going to go into Sturt's attacking zone, but it'll come back quickly as Spinner takes it and goes short to Grove. And Grove's kick is good, and it finds Thring. So Maxi hugs the line. Shannon made front spot, did well. Lean it at the back, forced the issue. Shannon again, second effort was good. Oh, Barnes was clever to nearly get it around his opponent there in McMahon. But the boundary line again wins out, right in front of the scene at Sturt crowd over there. Enjoying some fine wine, some fine food. And they're enjoying a game and a half here at the moment. They're getting their money's worth. We hope you're enjoying it on the live stream. As the boundary umpire whips it back in. Barnes, Young, little toe poke by SDL, went back to Barnes. Schwartz heard the voice of Georgie Thring, spun around a couple, loaded up off one step, kicks inboard. Here's a chance, will it be kicked off the ground? Oh, Craig nearly got a foot to it before he cannoned into the padding of the goalpost. So a minor score, margin back to 12, 5-5, plays 3-5, two straight kicks in it. McMahon now. Undecided, Says I'll go to the elm tree pocket and find Leanit. Leanit, lovely kick of the ball, no exception. Young, well, he created the contest, and front and square was Crocker, who bypassed Young and went to Penfold, whose hand pass released Greenslade. They're away here, Sturt, in champagne style, but that's great work from Spinner. Great work indeed, using his body well. His whole side was under pressure if he didn't take that mark, and he did well, and his kick's a super one to find Barnes. Barnes now plays on quickly. Oh, that's just going to pick out a player here, and Guilfoy just back under courage. He knew Shannon was coming. Kick's good. And finds Page. Page now gets it back inboard to Evans. Evans to Lords, left half forward. Hanson harassed out of it. Great work then by Spinner, one of North's best so far today. Gave it across now to Wilkie. Wilkie's kick's good and finds Thring. Thring now with a quick hand pass to Virgin, who came streaming through. He sees George to his left. The kick goes that way. He holds things up. He's got the lead from Craig. Oh, Leanit did very, very well. You can pay that. 1-2. Just took the good mark. And Craig was on the burst, and that was courageous. His kick, not so good, but it sat up in the turf for Hone. But his hand pass only finds McKenzie from the Roosters, who squares it back inboard to his teammate in Schwartz. And Schwartz now, they're on here, the Roosters. Clisby on the switch. What can the skipper do? He looks up. Oh, he'd like that one again, I reckon. It's out in front at least of Harvey. If the boundary line wins out, then it's probably a win for North. Well, decided that it was a throw in. So Clisby, his kick probably needed to be better then. Harvey presenting. But yet another throw in. So Craig and Perella set themselves. Ball holds up in the breeze, so it's left to Crocker just to read it. But his kick went straight to Motlop, who couldn't apprehend the ball. Coming in and doing well was Carey. Martin, his little kick, put Kirkwood into a two-on-one. It was good from Wilkie. De Leonardis off a step from 51 metres out. The ball goes goalward. Stevens having all sorts of trouble collecting it. Eventually does to Guilfoy, and the Blues are away through Jonas. Little tap on the ground. Oh, the hand pass over the top was taken by Clisby, who sold a little candy. He said, you go this way, I'll go that way, and I'll unload the kick, and I'll unload a goal. And that's how you do it, boys. Skills personified from Mitch Clisby, the Roosters skipper, and they are back in business here. So Skip gets his first. Becomes the fourth goal scorer for North Adelaide and takes them to 4-5-29. They're back within a straight kick of the double Blues, 5-5-35. Sturt's only added the 2 points in this quarter. North Adelaide have added 3-1. Great work from Mitch Clisby there. It all resulted from just the intercept of the hand pass. And he finished it off with a little bit of candy selling and importantly kicked the goal. Back in the middle. As Perella and Craig, the two big men, go at it. Been a great contest between those two. Ground level. This is where it gets scrappy. And the ball's going nowhere. Again, as Craig does the roving and the rucking work. As many a good ruck does these days. Third man up was McKenzie. Eventually it came out through Wilkie, who got it to Schwartz. His kick inside 50 to Motlop in a one-on-one. What's he got up his sleeve here, Marlon? He just works it to the boundary line and he says, I'll be happy to see it over. McMahon, hot on his tail there. But good work from Motlop. That was clever. Shows some poise, some experience. You get that in your 64th game of SANFL IGA League football. Marlon Motlop. We're just waiting for the umpire to recall it back over his head. There's Barnes and Perella. Barnes got a little tap on it. Shannon just tried to palm it forward. Trying to create something here. McKenzie did well. A little scrubby kick now. And what have North Adelaide got? Can they get it out of there? Crocker just decides to try and paddle in front. It was good harassment from the Roosters. And we'll have a stalemate situation. Ball up again. So it's on the right half-back flank for Sturt. Martin shoveled it out. Good hands to Crocker. Worked with Battersby. Now with Slimming back to Crocker. Back to Battersby. Battersby off one step. Kick smothered. Craig under pressure. Knew the heat was coming. Now it's Slimming. Flipped the hand pass out to Martin, who got around one. Greenslade got around a couple. Working hard here. The Roosters defending stoutly. Wilkie Kick around the body, but it'll come back as it's set up for Crocker, who now has Stevens. Stevens this time says we'll thump it out of here. Young presented, couldn't take the mark. Great work from Grove. And the ball goes over the boundary line, just adjacent to the scoreboard, which says we've ticked over 20 and a half minutes of this second quarter. And the margin's only 6 points, with the Double Blues 5-5-35, North Adelaide 4-5-29. Perella and Craig set themselves. Craig won it out easy, took it out the ruck. Hand pass was good. Shannon just barged through, charged through, got it to Maxey, took a bounce from 53 out. He unloads with a tumbler and a wobbler, and it just dribbles over the boundary line. And that'll be a free kick to Scott McMahon from the Double Blues. He's been the recipient of a couple of those today, McMahon. And he's been a great pickup for the Double Blues since crossing back over the border from his days with North Melbourne. And he goes short to Stevens. And Stevens now loads up, kicks it long, Young, outpointed this time, and a good mark taken there by Grove. Grove now for the Roosters. Oh, he heard the little voice of George Thring, decided, well, I better put it on the boot now to the big fellas. Ryswick's back there, presented well. Shannon charging through, couldn't. Oh, here's Motlop. What can he create? Kick around the body. Just to the wrong side, minor score. So North Adelaide, they're back within a kick now. So 4-6-30, Sturt 5-5-35. Just 5 points the margin. And Sturt taking the ball out wide. And the kick has gone out of bounds on the full, as called by the boundary umpire. So George Thring squares it up, comes in board to Josh Gregg. So Gregg now for the Roosters. What can he do? Gee, wouldn't they love to take a lead into halftime here, North Adelaide, sitting ninth on the ladder against the Double Blues in third. The kick's good from Gregg to McKenzie. It's in the soft stuff out there. Loads up. Where's the big man? Barnes sets himself. Couldn't take it. Read at the front beautifully by Maxey. Can he create some magic again? Well, he can't even score a minor score this time, unfortunately. Just off the side of the boot. Just never know what you'll get with Max. He can be marvellous one moment. And the next, well, that can happen. Good pressure by the Sturt defence. They hold a 5 point margin. Martin just holds a little something off the kick. George Thring went early. Out the back was Young. He's no slouch at league level, I can tell you, this young boy. But there's a whistle gone. And it's coming back. And it's going to go back to Roone Guilfoyle for the Double Blues. So a whistle called on play. So Guilfoyle now with a chance to send Sturt forward. 23 and a quarter gone. Second quarter. Double Blues by five. Kick holds up in the breeze. Big fly from Beard at the back. Crashed the pack. Grove did well for the Roosters. Knows the boundary lines there. Knew Evans was coming. And decided, I'll just safely walk it over. Sure the umpire won't have any problems with that. And he didn't. So I'll have another throw in. Been a plethora of those today. Next to the perimeter of the picket fence of Peter Motley Oval. Ball at ground level now. Schwartz for the Roosters. Did well. Put Clisby under a lot of pressure though from Greenslade, and he's gone holding the ball. Well, he took the tackler on, and the tackler being Johnny Greenslade. You don't get away from him too often. Socks down. He's hard at it. One of the great tacklers of the competition. Goes with a high kick. Holding up in the breeze inside 50. Good mark at the back, Beard. Just read it the best of them all. And he looks for an option in board. He sold some candy, so now he has to load up to the hot spot. Harm sets himself. Big fly at the back here. And the ball's going to be forced through. See, Harms, he called for it. He sat for it. He just couldn't get the Dukes on it. Minor score. Back to a one straight kick margin. Sturt 5-6. North 4-6. 24 and a half gone. Kick out of defence now for the Roosters. Is good. Chance now here for Patterson. Looks forward, up the ground. Goes with a kick towards the middle of the ground there. Sets the task for DeLeonardis. He was nearly up to it, but slimming. Got the hand pass back to Guilfoyle. Off one step, nice, neat little kick. Good work back here by Patterson. He was crunched into the ground, into the back by Corey Beard. Just a little bit too aggressive. And young Patterson, once he gets himself out of the very, very soft turf out there, will take the free kick. So the Roosters a chance here. They're not without a chance to at least square the ledger before half time. Not a lot of time will be in time on. Punch at the back there. Schwartz gave off the don't argue, but it was intercepted by Big Andre the Giant, who just showed the ball and then a nice hand to Kirkwood. Kirkwood goes, squares it up now to Martin, who's got a player in Borden Hansen. He could almost kick it from here. He decides to strike it nicely to Beard. Couldn't take the mark. Soccer off the ground by Evans is dribbling. Another soccer off the ground. And I think it's come from Corey Beard. He's claiming it. And it is. Jack Penfold having no problems with that. He said, Corey, you can put that one against your name. So Beard slots his first in dribble kick style off a couple of soccer shots there. Zane Kirkwood the first and Corey Beard putting the finishing touches into the back of the net. So Sturt, they get that break again. A much needed one because North Adelaide were charging at them. So Beard's first, Sturt, they get their sixth. They're 6-6, 42, North 4-6, 30, 12-point margin, 26 and a quarter gone. They've kept Corey Beard fairly quiet today, North Adelaide. Their defence has been under pressure all day, as we know. But they're holding up nicely. They're still within reach. Back in the middle, Craig again, another tap down. Chance here, though, for Battersby. This is where they fall down. McKenzie under pressure from Greenslade. And he'll be going nowhere. Geordie McKenzie sporting the helmet. Easy to pick out. The umpires would have found him easy to pick out this season, too, for some votes in the McGarry coming up. Schwartz emerges from the traffic. Nice high kick. Oh, Thring worked Leonard out of it. Nearly fell into his lap too. De Leonardis gave off the don't argue. Saw Maxi there. Can he Thring get the ball out? He does. Saw Big the redhead Harvey. Goes over the top by hand. Chance for Shannon from 35 metres out. It is not going to miss. It did not deviate. And Jay Shannon, right on siren time, scores his second. And they're back within a kick. Wow, what a time to come. Some good play there. Great, hard, tenacious play from the Roosters. Thring was involved. De Leonardis was involved. Harvey eventually got it to Shannon, who kicked truly for his second, right on the siren. So at half time, Sturt still hold the lead. They're on 6-6, 42. They lead North 5-6, 36. It is just a 6-point margin. One straight kick in it. What a half of football. We'll go through your goal scorers and then we'll have a little look at the stats from the first half. And then, of course, a look at the other games around the grounds in SANFL IGA League round 21 action. We've got a ripper for you here at Peter Motley Oval. Goal scorers for the Double Blues. Multiple goal scorer Mark Evans with two, both in the first quarter. And singles to Greenslade, Hansen, Kirkwood and Beard. Beard, that timely goal. Just close to quarter time, and of course the response came from the multiple goal scorer from North Adelaide in Jay Shannon. He's got two, and singles to Clisby, Max Thring and Lee Ricewick. So at half time, repeating those scores, Sturt 6-6, 42, North Adelaide 5-6, 36, 6-point margin. In that quarter, North Adelaide kicking 4-2 with the breeze, Sturt managing just the 1-3 into it. So North Adelaide having the better of the scoring at the northern end, which they will be kicking to in the third quarter. Let's have a look at some of your major stats here, as we'll firstly have a look around the grounds at the scores from other games being played out in the SANFL IGA League this afternoon. Just refreshing the screen here for the scores up at the Berry Oval. Fourth quarter there, Adelaide 20-11, 131. Leading West Adelaide 9-6-60, so a big margin there, 71 points in favour of the Crows, so percentage could be important for them come September. At the moment, they came into this game with a percentage of 53.7. That will obviously improve. There's still a game behind the Double Blues, and of course the result will hinge on the next two quarters of football here at Peter Motley Oval, so Adelaide, they're giving it their best shot. They've gone up there to the Riverland and they are doing it very, very nicely. And the other game at Mourntee Hyundai Oval, where it's the Eagles 9-5-59, a 22-point lead over the Tigers 6-1-37 in the second quarter there. And down at Alberton, well, we heard that Norwood hadn't scored for the first quarter. Well, they finally got a goal, but they've only got the one. Port Adelaide, 9-6-60. They hold a 54-point margin over Norwood, one straight goal. We'll try and have a look at some of the stats for you from our game here, and we'll get those up for you and have a brief synopsis of proceedings for the first half of action here, which has been a fantastic game so far. Let's have a look at some of these stats as we bring them up, thanks to the SANFL app. Total match disposals, let's have a look at those. For the Double Blues, they lead that 194 to 175, kicking the ball 114 against 80 with their hand passes there. So pretty much standard for the Double Blues, using the ball a lot more by foot under the coaching of Marty Mackner. And kicks to handballs there, 105 kicks for the Roosters, 70 hand passes. So they're about where they do sit North Adelaide as far as percentage of use of the ball. As far as the marks go, well, it's 54 to 52, so fairly even in that count. Tackle counts even at 31 apiece, so 62 tackles there. It's been a bruising encounter. The hit-outs, 29 to 11 in favour of North Adelaide. Of course, James Craig doing very well, but been impressed by Andre Perella and also Lewis Young in his first game, doing some of the ruck work as well as sitting up forward. So giving big Andre the Giant some respite, but James Craig, well, he's just a standout as far as ruck work goes. But as we've said, where North Adelaide fall down is in that turning those hit-outs into clearances. Inside 50s, North Adelaide lead that 23 to 22. Sturt leading the rebound 50s, 17 to 14. Let's have a look at some of your key player stats. Zane Kirkwood leads with 16. He's equal with Marlon Motlop on the ground at 16 apiece. Matty Crocker for the Double Blues has 15, as does Roone Guilfoy. Jordy McKenzie for the Roosters and Mitch Clisby both on 14. Of course, the skipper kicking a ripper of a goal there in the second quarter. Jack Stevens, James Battersby and James Greenslade all in the high teens there. And Tommy Schwartz also with 12 disposals for the Roosters. Maxi Thring with 11, who kicked a cracking goal that certainly sparked the Roosters into life in that second quarter. Of course, some important goals there kicked in the second term. So that's how it stands at halftime here. At quarter time, it was 5-3 to 1-4. At halftime, it's 6-6 to 5-6. And just repeating those scores from the other ground, so you're all up to date with all things SANFL this afternoon. It is Adelaide by 71 points over the Bloods. It's the Eagles by 22 over the Tigers. And it's Port Adelaide by 54 over the Redlegs. We're going to take a little bit of a break here. We'll be back with all the second half action with you very shortly. And this is all thanks to our good friends at the Flight Centre, where you can give them a call on 131 600. Tell them you're a SANFL member. They'll invite you to come into one of their centres all around South Australia. Show your membership card and we'll take $100 off your next travel costs. So make use of that. And we hope you're enjoying the broadcast here. As you can see, the ground is bathed with the mini-leaguers and also spectators enjoying the beautiful sunshine, kicking a catch time here at Peter Motley Oval. And we'll be back with all the second half action for you very, very shortly. This is Don Cooper joining you on the SANFL live stream Dream Team this afternoon. And we'll have all that second half action, as I said, very, very shortly. And welcome back to your live stream coverage of round 21 action as North Adelaide already back out on the ground. Zane Kirkwood brings the double blues out onto Peter Motley Oval. Looking absolutely picturesque here this afternoon. The picket fences shining brightly in the sunshine. The mini leaguers have had their crack at the title. Kick and a catch coming to a close as the ground's clearing. The umpires are back out onto the ground. So things shaping up here to get ready for a second half of football. And if it's anywhere inch the quality that we saw in the first half, we are in for a ripping finish to this round 21 encounter. As we said, North Adelaide, their last appearance at league level this year. They now have two quarters to go. Their second was very, very good. In that second quarter, just to give you a recap of the match so far, at quarter time, Sturt kicking with probably what we think is about a three-goal breeze favouring the southern end of Peter Motley Oval. Got away to a flyer. They were 5-3, 33-1, 4-10 at quarter times. They held a 23-point margin. It was out as much as 29, but it was brought back by Jay Shannon kicking a late goal to the northern end. Second quarter came along. Sturt, they struggled into the breeze. North Adelaide found some venom up forward and they kicked four goals to the Roosters with the breeze. They bring the margin now back to 6 points. Sturt could only manage 1-3 into the breeze. That goal came off a soccer-style kick from Corey Beard after a real goal square scramble. North Adelaide's goals coming from some different approaches. Mitch Clisby and Maxi Thring got into a little bit of magic there. Lee Ryswick running into an open goal. And Jay Shannon with a nice 9-9 kick through the middle right on the siren to bring that margin back to 6. So it's been an exciting encounter here. We hope you're enjoying it at home, watching and listening this afternoon on the SANFL IGA League live stream, www.sanfl.com.au, where you can get all your news, anything SANFL, and also brought to us by the Flight Centre, our good friends. And we are really enjoying their association with the live stream this season. You can take your SANFL membership along to any one of their centres. Give them a call on 131 600. Tee up a time to pop in and see one of the fabulous representatives there. They're great people to deal with. They'll help you out on your next travel venture. And they'll even take $100 off the cost of it when you show your SANFL membership. So things starting to get ready for this second half. North Adelaide coming into their huddle. Sturt now drawing their group together. The umpires just going through some preliminary bounces. They've done a great job out there today, the men in green. Bouncing the ball beautifully in tough conditions. As we said, this swirling breeze, probably about a 3-goal breeze favouring the southern end. Sturt, we saw how well they used it in the opening quarter. Let's see what they can do in the third stanza. Have a great performance so far. Just a quick check of other grounds. Thanks to our good friends at Flight Centre. We'll fly around the other grounds. In the last quarter there, it's Adelaide 23-14, 152, leading West Adelaide 13-7-85. So that is a 79-point margin there in favour of the Crows. The Eagles, as we said, are up by 22 points at halftime down there at Mourntim Hyundai Oval. And it's a 54-point lead to the Magpies at Alberton Oval. So some big scores there, particularly to the Crows and the Magpies. Of course, on the back of both sides playing in the showdown last night at AFL level. Talked about some of those hit-outs to clearances. North Adelaide ranked second in the hit-outs, thanks mainly to the work of one of the best in the business, James Craig. Sturt ranked ninth, but in the clearances, Sturt are ranked third and North Adelaide eighth. So you talk about the hit-out to clearances average. Sturt are almost a plus one from hit-outs to clearances. North Adelaide are minus 11. So Sturt, their midfield, is a gun midfield at that. We know it's led by Zane Kirkwood. It involves Brodie Martin as well. North Adelaide, well, they've got one of the best in the business too. One of the competition stars in Jordy McKenzie. Look forward to seeing how well he polls on McGarry Medal night. This, his final step out in the Roosters jumper for 2016. We're almost set to go. Back in the middle. And here we go. Third quarter action, round 21. Perella against Craig. The former got it down to Battersby. Links up with Martin. They're straight through the middle. Sturt on the lead up, and the pass is good from Martin and finds Evans. He'll kick from 50. on about a 45, 50 degree angle. Not without the realms of possibility, the Double Blues could have a goal within the first 30 seconds of the third quarter. So Evans comes in. He kicked two in the first quarter. He stutters, crosses the paint of 50, strikes it, and he pumps the air. He knows he's kicked it. As soon as it left the boot, Mark Evans has got his third. Sturt have got their seventh. Well, what a start. Within the first 45 seconds, the Double Blues are on the board. Mark Evans there on the end of a beautiful pinpoint pass from Brody Martin, who got the handball from James Battersby, who got the tap down from Big Andre the Giant. And that's how they do it. It was almost like a training drill. Clear purchase on the footy, good foot skills, and that's where they've dominated today, using the ball by foot, the Double Blues. Margin back to 12. Back in the middle. Perella had to sit underneath it. Flipped out the back. Martin again to Battersby. The combination. Again, lean it at his foot laces. Got it. Thumped it with a 65-metre bomb at the back. Great spoil there from Patterson. The ball, though, it sits for Hansen, who just wheeled around, looked up, and he had Evans again. Good Evans. He's running right, Mark Evans. He's right in front of goal this time. Ben Hansen doing the team thing. He was on a tough angle, but he decided to look inboard, and he saw Evans leading up into open space, took the mark, and he's going to go back and he'll strike this one from about 38 metres out, directly in front. Angle not a problem. Distance not a problem. And accuracy's not a problem. Evans has got four. And the Double Blues are off to a flyer in this third quarter. Gee, danger signs already. We saw this happen in the opening stands in North Adelaide, just letting the Double Blues get off the leash a little bit. And there wouldn't be too many players who've even touched the leather for the Roosters in this quarter. We're nearly two and a half gone. It's been all Sturt. It's been all Perella, Martin, Battersby, Lean at that time, joining in, and Hansen getting involved as well. It's a fair bit of work to do in there for the likes of Schwartz and McKenzie now for the Roosters. Was the ball thrown high? Craig with the tap down. Shannon. Well, he doesn't ask for any quarter to be given. And he charges through. And a free kick received. There's a player that never goes down questioning his performance and his endeavour. He wants Clisby to go to one side, so he decides to scamper off the other. The kick now to right half forward is good and finds Harvey in open space. This is better. Harvey's kick, though, was terrible. And it's just picked off by McMahon for the Double Blues. McMahon now, he's got options left, right and centre, decides to go right. And that's where he finds Jack Stevens, nearly in the goal square. So Stevens now decides to go back to McMahon, who has to shield his eyes, dropped it, had time to, but there's a kick coming back. The umpire decided there was a 50 implied, so McMahon now restarts, underway, slimming, did well, paddled it in front of him, overran it to the second chance, Schwartz in there for North Adelaide, McKenzie now. Hand pass comes out to Shannon, chipping little kick, put Ryswick under pressure, but courageous was Ryswick in taking the mark, but again they're held up. Sturt's two-way running, just hurting the Roosters at the moment, kick inboard's good to find Clisby. Clisby now the skipper, defensive side of centre wing. 12-point margin, four gone, third quarter. Clisby's kick to George Thring, who has a bounce. Long-range kick inside 50. At the back was Barnes, good spoil. McKenzie hands and knees, pickpocketed though by Jonas. Put it out in front of Kirk with the two nines in there. McDonough harassing, comes out now to McKenzie for the Roosters. Kick around the body, lands into open space. And as no one touched it, we'll see a free kick to the Double Blues. Chance gone begging there, probably, as the kick comes out to Battersby. He goes by hand inboard to Martin. Heard the voice of Kirkwood, and why wouldn't you acknowledge that? Short little kick to Penfold. Releases Hansen into trouble. Ran straight in a spinner, but clever by Hansen. Although Penfold overran it. Greg's in there, fighting hard for the Roosters. Grove in there lending support, and the umpire says, I'll have it, thanks, fellas. Good contest. Great determination from Josh Gregg to hold it in there as Craig taps it down. Shannon couldn't take it. Martin could. Kirkwood got an inside-out barrel that falls in front of Greg, who did well to keep it in front of him. Little Jackson there harassing him. Penfold, the ball dragged back in. How will the umpire see this one? He says, I'll have it. There's the ball pinned in there with Crocker, making sure it was going nowhere. Craig again. Again wins the hit out. Kirkwood strong in the clinches. Slimming, clever. Lean it. Oh, sold some candy. Went one way, then the other. Back to Greenslade. Now to Martin from 53. Great smother by McDonough. Good pressure by the Roosters. And McKenzie, a lovely pass, finds Barnes at full stretch. So Barnes now looks up. He's got Harvey. He's been good, Harvey, today. Guilfoyle was better, though. Uses Crocker. They've got too much support here, Sturt. Now Battersby to Evans. And great pressure from Shannon, forcing the spoil to the plaudits of Geordie McKenzie. He liked that one. And that's what you want to see a little bit more of from North Adelaide, that pressure, the defence. Man on man, one on one. As Motlop's coming off, just holding his hand at the moment. So we hope he's okay for Roosters supporters. Perella with a tap down. Shannon bullocking, working hard. Tierley now freed the arms. It spat out. That's okay, said the umpire. Battersby in there. McKenzie. They're all scrapping, fighting. The umpire says, I'm going to have to call it up, boys. The umpire Crosby comes in as Tom Harms gets off the bottom of the pack. He's used to being there. Perella just being used as a rag doll by Craig in that ruck contest. McKenzie at ground level, buried into the turf. Right in front of your broadcast position. Don Cooper with you on the live stream this afternoon. Throw up, lean it, third man up. Home went without it, so did Greenslade. Everyone's going without it. McKenzie sat upon. Surely he couldn't be gone. Oh, he is. Well, I don't know how he was ever going to get the ball out of there, and he was the only one going for it. That's the anomaly of the rule. As lean it, the beneficiary, squares it up to Battersby. What's Battersby got in front of him? He's got little Jack Penfold. Overran it, comes out the back, kick around the body is by Crocker. And don't tell me, Matty Crocker has just iced that one. Great goal, he just picked it up. Well, it came as a result of the free kick to lean it. He just went in board, and Crocker was on the end of it. So he adds his name to the goal scorers. And he becomes goal scorer number 6 for the Double Blues. Matty Crocker with his first. Sturt with their ninth. They're 9-6-60. North Adelaide 5-6-36. That margin getting out again now. 24 points. Back in the middle. Perella staring down Craig. Perella has to sit underneath it. Craig just slapped it out of there nicely. Lean it. Got a nice little slick hand pass out, but it was read beautifully by Mad Max. Kick was smothered, though. Tumbling ball towards Harvey. Couldn't get hands on it. Oh, Maxie was clever again. But it'll be a disposal out of bounds. And it will count as a stat for Max, but it'll be a free kick for the Double Blues. So Stevens now on the end of the pass. Back in the goal square. His defensive goal square. Has to go short and finds Lean it. The big rangy number 27 getting plenty of the ball. We know he's a thumping kick. But lean it. Goes long and wide to the outer side of Peter Motley Oval. Looking for a teammate there in Crocker. Had to flick it back over the top of the head cleverly. Jonas was there to lend support. The Roosters need numbers. Craig's in there for them. But paddling it forwards, Crocker. He's fast, but he ran into trouble. He ran into trouble indeed, did he ever? And he ran into Wyatt Patterson, who caused the 50-50 contest. And that was great work from the young man, Patterson, for the Roosters. Crunching tackle. Craig now taps it down. De Leonardis did well. Kick was smothered. Crocker, oh, just pole-axed by Craig. That was rugby-style tackle. Big James saw the opportunity and went straight into the ribs of Matty Crocker. Forced the ball up. So from the restart, rucks separate, come back together. Craig flipped it out the back. Trying to kick it along, Sam De Leonardis. Kirkwood in there. Players buried into the ground. Clisby, the tackler. And the player getting up is Battersby. He's actually been given the free kick. So Clisby, again, we're seeing a couple of these holding the ball decisions now. Clisby goes back in board, and that's a courageous mark taken there by Greg under the fierce presence of Tom Harms. So Greg now goes short and finds George Thring. So GT has the ball in hand, spinning it around. What's he got ahead of him? Decides to go bang inside 50. There's a lead up in Ryswick and it hits him on the big white V. Great pass, great lead up. Good to see some space being created. And if ever a man's going to do it, it's going to be Lee Ryswick. What can he do with the kick? At the left-hand goal post and bring it back to the right, I'd say, would be the best result for Roosters supporters. He strides in, strikes it nicely. It's fading. Ball punched away, still in play. Blues defence back there, working it nicely. How will it sit? Crocker again crashes into Clisby. He's having a hard time of it at the moment, Matty Crocker. And eventually it's going to be a free kick. No, the umpire, they're consoling each other. Consultation, I should say. No need to console each other, they've got it right. Boundary throw in. Perella, Craig. Craig, the latter wins it. Out the back, McDonough shrugged one, then the other. Got it out the back to Maxi. What can Maxi do? He lines up and he's just missed. So Thring, exciting player today, Maxi. Just the minor score. We're just waiting. There's a whistle here. It appears McMahon has overstepped the line or at least put a toe on it. As the umpire comes up to explain, your foot must be behind the line, Scott, not on the line. Not any portion of it. So we're going to have a ball up in the danger zone with a 23-point margin in favour of the double Blues. What can North Adelaide do here? Ground level. Players on hands and knees. Comes out the back. Chance for Thring. Can he got something there? No, he didn't have any support either. Martin to Carey to Crocker to Harms, and they're away. The double Blues now through Carey to Penfold. Whistle gone. Downfield. So Penfold has it, and he's got Evans in open space. Mark number three for him this quarter. Chips it, looking for Beard. Oh, diving under the fierce pressure of Tahana. Took the sliding mark right in front of your broadcast position. Beard goes back to go forward. Finds Kirkwood, helping the umpire out with where the mark is. He decides to square it up across the ground to McMahon. Another lateral kick. The switch is on here to lean it. Corralled by Barnes. Oh, lean it, getting himself into trouble with being too cute today. Ball at ground level now. McDonough sweeping in on its Tierley. Flipped it out the back, but it was stolen by Martin. Off the left boot, searching for Evans. Did well. Tried to shrug the tackle. Grove did very well. Thring now of the George variety. Just hacked it forward. An accidental kick. How will the umpire see that one? And he'll say, that's a boundary throw-in. No problems with that. Ball about to be spun back in. As Lewis Young on debut for the double Blues, league side against Barnes. Ladder got the tap down. Martin working well. Oh, Young did nicely. The kick almost fortuitously went to Hansen. There's a whistle gone and Hansen will get the free kick. And it all came from the work of young Lewis Young, the 17-year-old, the big rangy lad who's come up from the double Blues Macca's Cup side. Got it on the shoe and found Ben Hansen. It was just scragged too much by Stephen Tahana and Hansen will go back and line up for his second. Tough angle. Elm trees in the background. That's a perfect kick. Punches the air. That's a beautiful strike of the leather. Hansen, his second. The double Blues, their 10th. Sturt travel along now. 10-6-66. North Adelaide 5-7-37. That margin again back to the game high. 29 points after Ben Hansen strikes his second goal of the afternoon. The double Blues doing it nicely now. North Adelaide, they're under the sort of pressure they felt in the first quarter. We saw how they responded in the second, but they need to go a little bit earlier here. 14 and a half gone, third quarter. 29-point margin back in the middle. Barnes, this time, in the ruck work. Gets the tap down. McKenzie, ground level, charging through McDonough for the Roosters. Couldn't get his hands free. We'll have another ball up. Young wants to get a bit of a run at this one against Barnes, who's just looking for the body of Young. Where is he? He's up over the top of you, Alex, but he got the tap down. Well done by Barnes. Home got the kick, but Patterson for the Roosters got the intercept. But Patterson now loads up towards Centre wing grandstand side. Harms pushed underneath it by Barnes. Harvey did well. Barnes in open space. The big man, oh, he was decapitated by the Battersby tackle, and a free kick. The big Barnes. He's throwing the arms forward, so get down there. I'm going to launch this one. Got a sweet strike on it too. Who's there? De Leonardis with a big jump. Couldn't take it. He gets in for a second effort though. Good work from the Roosters, locking it in. Harms is in there for the double blues and we'll have a ball up. Sam De Leonardis, he looked likely. He was looking to be sky high Sammy there, but he couldn't get a good run at it. Good tap back from Young. It's into the hands of Leanett, but he's wrapped up by De Leonardis. McDonough, and we'll have a ball up. Ball thrown high now. Craig with the tap down, charging through Shannon, just almost handed it to Motlop. Thought about the kick around the body, gave it to Greg, who finds Tierley in open spaces. Can he ice it? No, he can't. Wrong side of the stick. It's normally where he's very, very dangerous from there, Cohen Tierley. He just couldn't bring it back enough that time. Minus score. The North Adelaide now, 5-8-38. The Double Blues, 10-6-66. 16 and a half gone, third quarter. Margin 28 as Leanett to himself. And then with a long range bomb that Barnes just punches into the picket fence, sends it out of bounds, and we'll have a throw in about 75 metres around from North Adelaide's goal in the shadows of the Mackay Grandstand. Beautiful day for football, big crowd in attendance, and Barnes gets the tap. Ricocheted off Swartz to Tierley, who just saw McKenzie at the corner of the eye, and his kick's perfect. And on the end of it is Big Harvey. So what can Mitch do? Yet to kick a goal today, Mitch Harvey. 34 goals from 17 matches coming into this one. And he's right up against the fence. So he's on about a 60-degree angle. He'll kick it from 50. He almost has to hit it towards the behind post at the northern end for it to come back. Nice kick, but it's going to fade right across the face of goal. I haven't learned all day on that kick. At the bottom of the pack's Martin. Emerges with the ball by hand to Battersby. They go back inside and they work it beautifully. And Martin again on the end of it with a nice kick to Perella. Big Andre. They're calling for it to move forward. Penfold darting around. Goes by hand to Martin. Now to Crocker. Took the mark. Played on. He's got Hone by hand. Has to get around a couple. He does. In Schwartz and Tierley. And the kick's nice and finds Carey in front of McKenzie. So Carey swings it wide. Across the ground. Finds Page. Had a startling start to the game. A little bit quiet since. By hand to Stevens. Stevens. Oh, look who's this up the ground. Scotty McMahon. He says, I'll have a little piece of this, boys. We're in some good form. I'd like to kick a goal. So McMahon, who's drifted from the back pocket, has come all the way up the ground. And McMahon, who's only kicked the three goals in his SANFL IGA League career before today, could make it number four. And this could really hurt North Adelaide. A little bit of coast-to-coast action. McMahon, deliberate approach. Kicks on its way. Goal umpire backs back a little bit, but that's a great goal. They'll get around Scotty McMahon. He's drifted from the back pocket to the forward pocket, and he's fulfilled that goal beautifully. McMahon's first. Sturt get their 11th. They're 11-6-72. That margin now a game high 34 points with North Adelaide on 5-8-38. And Scotty McMahon. Game number 17 in the Double Blues jumper today. Goal number four. So he can kick him, but he doesn't kick him too often. About one in four. And he made sure of that one. Beautiful strike of the ball. 34-point margin, 19 and a half gone. We're in the shadows of time on. Whistle gone, no whistle gone. Play goes on. Ball comes back to Virgin now for North Adelaide. Sweeping hand pass, releases Tierley onto his favoured left foot. High kick looking for Tahana, who's just worked underneath it by Harms beautifully and allowed Stevens to take the mark. So Stevens inboard on the 45, finds Carey, who scampers off, sees the lead on right half forward of Battersby. Good pressure from Tierley, did real well to back into that one. He's got support there in Virgin, 2-on-1 and the Roosters hold it in. Ball up results. Umpire Crosby throws it skyward. Perella tried to throw Craig out the way, but the latter got the tap down. Battersby read it, though, beautifully to Martin, whose kick was a real scrubby little one at the toes of Evans, who couldn't get a good look at it. And eventually he's tackled by Callum Wilkie. Going nowhere, and there'll be a ball up. Umpire Bennett throws it high. Young comes in, tap down. McKenzie just stood nicely, got it out the back to Clisby. His kick was good, touched off the boot, but Motlop was clever. Dropped the shoulders, gave it off to McKenzie, and then went with Schwartz on McMahon, flying over the top of DeLeonardis. But SDL did well, gave off the don't argue, and then went by hand to Virgin, whose kick's good and finds Ryswick. Ryswick now, attacking side of centre wing, out of sight of Peter Motley Oval. Terrible kick at the bootlaces of Tahana, and eventually a boundary throw-in will result right over in front of the family-friendly area here at Peter Motley Oval, which is bathed in sunshine this afternoon. Hope you're enjoying the broadcast. It's real danger signs, though, for North Adelaide. They're going to need a final quarter like their second to get back into this. Perella got the front spot, slapped it down. McKenzie has had a great game for the Roosters. His kick inside 50 forces the Sturt defence to work hard. Harms is in there. His kick favoured Perella, but good work in there by Craig. Motlop now out the back, trying to barge through with Shannon. Got it onto the boot. Where's the big man? Barnes! A barnstorming mark, if you don't mind. So Big Alex, a chance now to go back and slot a goal, a much-needed one for North Adelaide. The big man, 198 centimetres, put the telescopic dukes up and he clunked it. Great mark under pressure. Can he finish it off with a goal? The Barnes, deliberate approach, head over the football. He'll strike it from about 35 metres out. And you couldn't get any more directly in front. Kicks on its way. Goal umpire doesn't move. Great goal, Alex Barnes. His first. North Adelaide get their sixth. They're 6-8-44. The Double Blues 11-6-72. Margin now back to 28. Great work there from North Adelaide. They did it very, very well. They're hanging in there. And Big Alex Barnes, he's a big target. And when the ball went up high, it was at the perfect spot for him to have a run and a jump at it. And when he jumps at 198 centimetres and puts those long arms up, there's not too many players in the business that can come through and spoil that. Not even Jared Leanett at 196, a couple of centimetres in it. But that's all it takes, especially when Barnes got the hands around it and took a beautiful mark. 23 minutes gone, third quarter. 28-point margin. Back in the middle, this time Schwartz, clearing kick for the Roosters is good and finds Thring. They're getting up and about now, the Roosters. Maxey goes to right half forward. He was looking for Ryswick, but getting back was Page. Just put his body in the way of Ryswick and Motlop, the intended targets. And Ryswick again in there, forcing a stalemate, and we'll have a ball up. Right half forward for North Adelaide, 60 metres out from their goal. They trail by 28. They got the margin back to 6 at half-time after being 23 at the first break. What can they do from here? The restart, just players, it's congestion. And it's another ball up. A big James Craig just working tirelessly. Pulls himself up off the ground. Gets set for this next contest against Perella. Third man up, Schwartz. They've been doing that nicely today. Ducking the head was Crocker, tackled over the line, a good tackle too. Well done by Clisby. A little bit of push and shove coming from Battersby. We know he's been involved in a little bit. Page and Thring and Tommy Harms coming in, sorting out the students. Ball thrown back in. McKenzie handed it off to Clisby. One step around the body, kick inside 50. Almost a miraculous mark taken. Wasn't Page, said the umpire. Maxey Thring pleading with the umpire. And Harms just says, just play to the whistle, Max. It's a ball up. Perella taps it down. Chance down here for Schwartz. Good tackle. And a ball up results. So Harms that time, finding his way into the tackle of Schwartz. Battersby now from the stoppage. Tap down from Perella, but going nowhere. So we'll have another stoppage again. who ticked over the 25-minute mark of the third quarter. Perella got the little tap down. Kirkwood just slammed it on the boot. Didn't even look. Just said, get it out of here. McKenzie now for the Roosters. Heard the voice of Craig. Did well with the looping hand pass to Georgie Thring, who loads that up inside 50. Barnes, was he being held? It doesn't matter. He's got hold of the footy. Doesn't matter who's got hold of him. Big Alex. The Barnstorming Barnes. Can he make it two in a matter of minutes and get North Adelaide back to within a point where, with the use of this breeze in the final quarter, they may well consider themselves a chance? So what can Alex Barnes do? His last kick was textbook. From 30 metres out, very, very slight angle. Kicks on its way. Deja vu. Right on the siren, almost a la Jay Shannon style in the second quarter. Alex Barnes kicks his second, gets North Adelaide right back into this contest at three-quarter time. Well, it doesn't come any more timely than that. And at the last change, with just one quarter left in season 2016 for the Roosters League outfit, they get themselves back to within 22 points. So at three-quarter time, it's the Double Blues, 11-6-72, leading North Adelaide 7-8-50. We'll go through your goal scorers. For the Double Blues, Mark Evans has four. Two in the first, two in the third. He likes that southern end of Peter Motley Oval, that's for sure. Ben Hansen has two. And singles to Greenslade, Kirkwood, McMahon, Beard and Crocker. While for the Roosters, multiple goal scorers are Jay Shannon with two, Alex Barnes with two, both in that third quarter. And singles to Clisby, Max Thring and Ricewick. So last change. We've got a game here. It's only a 22-point margin. We saw what North Adelaide could do in the second quarter. They kicked four goals, two on that occasion. To Sturt's one goal, three. If they can replicate that, they're almost a sneaky chance here. They've been playing some really good footy this afternoon. Their endeavour's been fantastic. Josh Carr would be wrapped with this effort, but it means nothing if they can't finish it off in their last 30 minutes of football. Marty Mattner, on the other hand, well, he's got a fight on his hands, and this is good. Good preparation for his boys coming into September. We'll have a look at some of the key stats, and then we'll go around the grounds and see what's been happening in all other things SANFL this afternoon. So let's have a look at some of the key performers from this game here at Peter Motley Oval. Team stats first, 265 to 234 disposals in favour of the Double Blues. 154 kicks to 140. They lead that. 111 handballs to 94. They lead that. Marks, the Double Blues also in front there, 74 to 66. Tackles though, North Adelaide, they've been ferocious today, 54 to 47. They have chased a few jumpers, particularly in the first and third quarters, but they're going along nicely as far as their ferocity goes. The hitouts, they lead that 49 to 21, inside 50s 33 to 31, and a rebound 50s, the Double Blues leading that 25 to 18. As we said, it goes in there a lot from North Adelaide, but it also comes out too. Some key player stats. Jordan McKenzie, top disposal winner on the ground. No surprises with that. He's had an absolute cracker, Jordan McKenzie. 23 disposals. Zane Kirkwood, 22. Brody Martin, 22. And James Battersby, 22. So plenty there with the Richie Benno numbers there, the 22s. Marlon Motlop with 20. Matty Crocker with 20. Jared Leanett with 19. Mitch Clisby, he's starting to come into the game. The skipper from North Adelaide has 18. Jack Stevens with 17. Rune Guilfoy with a 16 and Maxi Thring with a 15. They round out the top disposal winners on the ground at the moment. Let's have a look at the scores around the grounds. The game finished up there at Berry, so it's a long road trip home for the Bloods. They went down 27-17, 179 to West Adelaide, 13-7-85, so that was a 94-point win. They managed to just hold the Crows at bay from a 100-point win, but that will have some real ramifications on the percentage table, because Adelaide, they came into this game, as we said earlier in the broadcast, on 53.7%. That percentage will skyrocket. They started only 1.4% behind Sturt. They may well have gained that, but the 2 points here Sturt will be desperate, because if they get the win here, percentage matters for nothing. Sturt will get the double chance. Lot on the line. We hope you're enjoying it. Your broadcast coming to you this afternoon on the live stream. Don Cooper, your host and caller. We've got Steve on camera doing a fantastic job bringing us all the vision. Hope you're enjoying that. Thanks to our good friends at the Flight Centre. And if you're a SANFL member, don't forget, call them on 131600. Book a time to go in to one of their centres around South Australia. Show your SANFL membership and they'll knock $100 off your next travel journey. And they'll also make sure you have the trip of a lifetime. They do it absolutely fantastically at the Flight Centre. I can speak about that personally. Used them before, absolutely use them every time I travel. North Adelaide breaking from the huddle. Marty Matner still has his troops locked in, listening to the last minute words of encouragement, words of advice, words of instruction. Josh Carr has got to the point now where he said, the season end is up to you boys. It's in your hands. He's backed them in. What have they got? 30 minutes time, we'll find out. They're down by 22, but they're not down and they're not out yet. Looking forward to a big last quarter here at Peter Motley Oval. Big crowd in attendance too. We can see them streaming off the ground here in readiness for the players to take centre stage. The last stanza of a fantastic performance is ahead of us. And the crowd's been enjoying it. As we said, plenty of red and white. Great to see them coming down from North Adelaide. They follow their side through thick and thin, the red and white supporters, and they'll cheer them on to the very end. They've got their reserves team in the finals, as we said. They've locked down fourth spot after a win over the Double Blues earlier today. So they've still got some September action ahead of them. They won't be in the league outfit for the Double Blues supporters, though. Can they lock down the double chance? So it's a big double opportunity here for Sturt. Take the win and finish in the top three. So the Double Blues double chance hinges on this. Umpire Bennett about to get us underway. The ground cleared. Last scan of the oval. Just watch out, Zane, I'm coming back that way. And umpire Bennett's going to get us underway. Craig Perella, the big man, staring across the 10-metre circle. Bang goes the burly. Craig slapped it out of there. Went past Maxi Thring. Picked up by Leanert. Got it to Martin nicely. His kick out in favour of Beard. It sat nicely. Back pedals by Hander Slimming. Goes with a short little pass back to Leanert. Centre wing, defensive side. His kick looking for. Nearly found Page. Tierley overzealous in the tackle, said the umpire. And that was on Battersby. So Battersby will take the free kick. Tierley just not getting down low enough there. But Battersby was put under pressure by the Leanert kick, who's normally very good by foot, and Sturt have been good by foot today. So Battersby's kick towards right half forward trickles over the boundary line. There'll be a free kick to North Adelaide. And it goes short to Shannon. So Shannon now, left half back flank, out of sight of Peter Motley Oval. And he looks to go down the line towards the centre wing where Harvey presents front spot. Good spoil away by Guilfoy. Sees it safely over the boundary line. Right in front of Deb Curtis there, your SANFL photographer. One of the best in the business. Always look forward to her shots on the SANFL website, so make sure you check them out. The ball spins back into play. Craig Perella. Perella tried to soccer it out. Shannon just popped one over the top by hand to Clisby. He tried to flick it out the back, but Crocker was there. Gave it off to Leanert. Leanert strides away and a searching kick looking for Young, but it bounced the wrong way, but it set beautifully if you Lee Ryswick. He looks left, he looks right, he gives way. Now he has to give the ball to Patterson, who's just locked up by Crocker, thrown away. Ryswick came back to lend support. The kick at the bootlaces of Stevens for the Double Blues. Did well under pressure. Got it by hand to Page, who farmed it out to McMahon, who's kicked a goal today. Not one of his best kicks, though, and it's picked off by Patterson. So Wyatt Patterson now. What's he got ahead of him? Shannon's at right half forward. It's going to come that way. He doesn't see it coming, though. All of a sudden, he's involved. Harvey presented, crashed the pack. Barnes at ground level. The big man did well. Got rid of it. Lean locked up by Motlop. And eventually, the umpire says, we'll have it. Has a ball up. just before it went over the boundary line. So umpire Lewis calls the rucks forward. About to throw it up. Perella and Barnes. Perella gets front spot. Barnes nearly outreached him. Shannon got first hands on it. The ball up results before Schwartz could get away. The only stat there was the hand pass back to Giles Lewis, the umpire. So thrown skyward again. Perella this time. Nice hands down to Slimming. Released home but went without it. Thring nearly got hold of him and he did, but it was too high. He honed in on him all right, but Josh got the free kick. There's a 25 being paid. It's coming up the ground. So Crocker won't get the benefit of the mark. And home will take the kick again. This time he's going to go across the ground the other side. He's got his teammate lurking. The kick will come back now from Jonas to Stevens. Stevens goes short and finds Guilfoy. They're just doing it quietly here at the moment, Sturt. They're prepared to make North Adelaide wait. There's another short kick to Jonas. Guilfoy will get it back in the 1-2. Now they'll come, Jack Odie's side, if Leanett can get his hands on it, because Barnes is fast approaching. We know that Jared's been a little bit slow in this situation. The kick was terrible to Crocker, but Crocker's speed got him out of trouble. Took a bounce, changed lanes, got the hand pass out to Young, who just had butter on the ball there for a moment. He couldn't pick it up. Good pressure from North Adelaide. Kick squeezed out by McMahon. Oh, great work by Patterson there, just to paddle it over as Young and Georgie Thring. Well, George is just welcoming him to league football, and big Andre comes in and says, "Hey, Georgie, that's enough. I think I'll just knock you over." Anyway, while all that's happening, we've got a whistle and a free kick to Craig. Goes across the ground. He's got Ryswick in open space. What can the speedster do? He's too far out to score, even with this breeze. But he decides to drill it, looking for Barnes over the top of his head. And it only sits for Guilfoy for the double blues. He sweeps the hand pass out, looking for Battersby, who does likewise over the top to Slimming. And Slimming's kick puts Kirkwood under all sorts of pressure. It was well done by Ryswick not to give away the free. Clisby now, the recipient of that, gives it to McDonough from 51 with a thumping kick. Miraculous Matt McDonough. What a great goal. And the skipper involved again, Mitch Clisby, working hard. Well, Sturt, they were pressed and pressed by North Adelaide there defensively, and eventually the Roosters got the reward on the scoreboard. Off the boot of Mac McDonough, his first timely one to come along. North Adelaide, it's their eighth. They're 8-8-56, Sturt 11-6-72. Just over 5 1/4 gone. Last quarter, 16-point margin. We have a game again. It's been like this all day. Sturt have held North Adelaide at arm's length. The Roosters have come back. Sturt have given them the don't argue again, but back come the Roosters. Craig with the tap down, honed for the double blues. Weaving one way, then the other. Little bounce, little hand pass. Over the top to Leanett. Oh, here's trouble here. Maxi Thring's underneath that. Popped it out. Charging in was Jonas to try and lend support, but a ball up results. Bit of push and shove. Harms is in there. Maxi Thring. He was looking to do a switch there with Michael Virgin on the bench, but not the time to do it. Perella with the tap down. Schwartz, good hands. McKenzie over the top. Good work. In tight, tough. Doing it well was Craig. The hand pass went back, but locked up. And again, Jared Leanett doing well to hold up Maxi Thring. Perella, Craig again. Craig won it out. McKenzie heard the little voice. Oh, could have been a trip there on Tierley. No, it was high actually against Hone. So Cohen Tierley just had his legs taken from under him, but Schwartz took Hone too high. And a couple of head high tackles already in this quarter, Josh Hone. He's not afraid to put his head over the ball and he goes short to Martin under pressure from Shannon. Good work, great contested mark. Well done by Shannon not to give away the free kick too. And Martin goes short. Nice, neat little kick to Kirkwood. He just scurries off and kicks it wide and it's picked off by Harvey. The big man did well. He just read that beautifully where it was going, the intended target, McMahon. So Harvey loads up looking for Ryswick. Second bite of the cherry. Couldn't take it. The Sturt defence come in. Guilfoy's in there and locks it in Unfortunately for Roosters fans, Ryswick just couldn't get that second grab. That would have been timely. A goal there and it's back to 10. And it's anyone's game from there. Critical time for the Roosters. Taken out of the ruck by Barnes. Banged it onto the boot. Double blues there. Clisby read it well. He celebrates as he kicks it. Have a look at him get around. Mitch Clisby, a ripper from the skipper, has got the Roosters back in business. Fantastic goal. He just read that, and as soon as he kicked it, the arm went up in the air. He knew it was bending back, and it went straight through the middle. So Clisby gets his second. Kicked one almost like that in the second quarter. He gets one in the last quarter, and that margin now back to 10 points. North Adelaide's ninth. They're 9-8-62. Sturt 11-6-72. We have a game and a half here at Peter Motley Oval on your live stream. Match of the day. Third place, Double Blues. Ninth place, Roosters. You wouldn't know it. Craig with the tap down. Schwartz with the possession, but he's wrapped up in the tackle by Kirkwood. And going nowhere, and we'll have a ball up. Still in the 10-metre circle. Thrown high. Crashing the pack was Tierley. Martin read it well. Tried to ride the bump in the tackle. Ball spits out. Harms a little toe poke. Picked up now by Schwartz. Kick quickly inside. Barnes, was he being held? Doesn't matter. Play on, said the umpire. Ball comes out now through Guilfoy, who got it from Crocker by hand. Kick looking for the boundary. It's going to find it, and it's going to be a free kick, North Adelaide. So McKenzie, leading possession winner on the ground. Should have it. No, it's been called a boundary throw-in, so it must have been touched. Well, there's a let-off there for the Double Blues. There's the ball thrown back in. Barnes in the ruck, just pushed Perella out the way. Oh, high tackle on Hone again. Is that number three? Yes, it is, said the umpire. He's got the little Joel Selwood moves happening at the moment, Josh Hone, and he's picking up the free kicks left, right and centre. He's not the biggest boy going around, Joshy. 175 centimetres. One of the Sturt Mosquito fleet. He scampers off, shapes to kick. He does now, and the kick is good to Jonas. So Jonas now, next player to get the mark would be Leanert, but that was good pressure from Tierley. Came in, didn't chop the arms, didn't take him high. And he just goes back to let Leanert know, I had your measure there, mate. You might be about 10 centimetres taller as Harms gets knocked over behind play by McKenzie. It's a little bit of feeling in this one. They've had some good stoushes in the past. They're having a great one here. Craig down to Schwartz, but picked off by Hone. Hone now with the hand pass. Back to Harms, who's dealt with after he kicked it. Got the kick away. That's a great mark by Wilkie. Flying up over the top. So Wilkie now squares it up. North Adelaide on the charge. What can they do? Spinner, been quiet. But what can he do here? It's a 65-metre bomb. It was looking for Motlop. Ball at ground level now. Sturt players in there. McMahon diving on it, trying to lock it up, and we'll have a ball up. Well, you just sense that the next goal's critical in this match. 10.5 gone of the last quarter. Round 21 action. There's only about 20 minutes left of football for this side, for the Roosters in 2016. As the kick goes forward now. Picked up here by Hansen. Went one way, then the other. Vision's good. See Slimming in open space. He can take his pick. He can give it off to Beard. The pass is beautiful. It sits for Corey. He wheels around off the outside of the boot, and he drills it. That could be the game sealer. Slimming to Beard. The Blom bombshells combining. The Corey Beard gets his second of the afternoon, courtesy of Steve Slimming doing the team thing. And the youngster getting some good applause, the 18-year-old, as he comes off the ground. Matty Crocker comes back on. That was unselfish. And it was good work through the middle of the ground by Ben Hansen. Been a great game from him. Even though a player like him can kick probably 60 metres, he knows when he should pull the trigger and when he shouldn't. The Double Blues, margin back to 16. Back in the middle. Scramble in the 10-metre circle. Finally, the ball emerges, courtesy of the kick of Harms, but it's intercepted by Greg for the Roosters. So Greg now kicks out, looking for Clisby. Couldn't take the mark. McMahon with a nice little look-away hand pass to Page. Says, I'll have it back in the 1-2. Thanks, Guy. So McMahon, a drilling kick, and finds Beard, who kicked that last goal. What's he got ahead of him? He's got a lead-up man. Goes over the top to Hansen, who can run into an open goal. And with a little check side, no, he decides to give it off. And goes bang. And the goal umpire says, I'm going to have to call it a point because Penfold got poleaxed. Well, it certainly wasn't a vintage Penfold then, because they mucked it up. Benny Hansen could have gone the right shoe, check side. Jack Odie would have been screaming at him from his grave. Just kick it off the outside of the boot, and he missed it. But ball back in play. That is a thumping, spiralling kick almost to the centre of the ground. It came off the boot of McDonough. Here's a chance now, North Adelaide. Through Thring of the George variety. Kicks towards right half forward, sitting underneath it is Virgin. Virgin looks up. He's got plenty of options. And Motlop's the first one, presenting up in front of Stevens, and takes a beautiful mark. And that was a thumping kick that came out of full back at the end of one of the most bewildering behinds I've seen in SANFL all year. How Ben Hansen decided he'd muck that up. Well, he'll have a good chance to have a look at back at that. It won't be on the highlights reel, but this might be. As Motlop comes in, can he get it back? It's a lovely kick. The arms in the air before the goal umpire picks the two fingers up. And Motlop celebrates. His first, North Adelaide, they're back in action. Still time. And after a kick like that, there's still a chance. The margin's only 11 points. We've gone 13 and three quarters in the last quarter, and this is shaping as a real thriller. And as soon as he kicked that, Marlon Motlop, the arm went up. So just have a look at that on the scoreboard. It's a lovely kick. Back in the middle. Just ticked into 14 minutes. We've got six plus change. Craig up against Young. Craig wins it down, does the roving. Hone does well, has his head ripped off again for the fourth time. This time the umpire says, you ducked into it. The crowd don't agree. And there'll be a little bit of fallout from that. He's getting up off the ground there from the McDonough tackle. Was Young. Time called. As umpire Bennett now throws it back up. Young, nice tap down to Battersby. Long range kick, looking for Evans, front and square. McDonough took on two, got the hand pass away to Wilkie. Nice little hand pass there, or Grove heard traffic coming, couldn't take the ball. And the free kick will go to Penfold, taken too high. Another one of the Mosquito fleet. Jack Penfold stands 174. Squares it up to Kirkwood, who didn't hear the footsteps of Tahana. Stripped of it. Oh, North Adelaide, they've mucked it up again. They had a chance to get away through Tierley, and the hand pass went straight to Guy Page. It was nearly another Page turnover. But Tierley wrapped him up. Ball thrown high. Craig with the tap down. Shannon didn't break stride. Nice, neat little hand pass to Virgin. Goes wider to Clisby. Back pedals, shuffled around. Brings it back inboard. He's got Tahana at full stretch. Unleashes Georgie Thring, 55-60 out. Goes looking for Motlop. Why wouldn't you, after he can kick like that? But Stevens did well. Goes back inboard to Guilfoyle by hand. Now Kirkwood. And Kirkwood just slows it down. Finds McMahon. So McMahon now, left half back. Long range kick. Down the wing, big fly, Beard, couldn't take it. Stolen by Greg, got the hand pass out, working his way through traffic there was Grove. Couldn't bullock his way through, players diving everywhere, desperate, tenacious. The umpire says, I'll have it. So 16 gone, last quarter. Perella comes onto the ground, straight into a ruck contest. Finds the tap down, but Schwartz from the Roosters took it, but he's wrapped up in the green slate tackle. We'll have a... another stoppage. Secondary ball up. There's a hush over Peter Motley Oval at the moment. The crowd just hoping, wanting. That's the home supporters. The Roosters willing their team on as DeLeonardis just hacked it out of the air. Oh, strong work by Maxie Thring. Just threw Page out of the way. Took the mark. Did it all legal-like too. Got it now out to Ryswick. Ryswick's kick in search of Virgin at full stretch. Takes it out in front of Leanett. He's got a lead up here in Motlop. What can he do? Oh, clever. Worked his opponent underneath the ball. Play on, said the umpire. Stevens with the tackle. Out in front of Leanett, but Leanett will just see it safely over the boundary line. So Motlop down behind plate, getting up now, so all okay. Saw him suffer a horrific fall from a high mark in round one. Wouldn't want to see him injured again. The boundary throw in as Perella and Craig. Great battle. Craig just paddling in front of him. Ball spits out now to McKenzie off the left boot. One step kick looking for Motlop. Couldn't take it. Does he get a second chance? No. Guilfoyle makes sure it goes over the line. But it's creeping closer to North Adelaide's goal. We've seen them score a few in situations like this. You need to keep your eyes out for those players lurking. Maxi Thring's there. De Leonardis there. Perella, Harvey, Schwartz for the Roosters. Got the hand pass out to Thring, who got it to Tierley off an impossible angle. And the mark safely taken by Guilfoyle. The Guilfoyle goes short. Just the required 15 to Crocker. In the right back pocket. Near the tennis courts and the elm trees. And that big crowd over there enjoying the match. In the eastern pocket as Beer takes a lovely, well-judged mark. Takes them better than almost anyone. Squares it up inboard to Leanit. Back inside defensive 50. Leanit has Page about 55 away and he hits him. Lace out. Page now with a spearing pass finds Jonas. They're stretching the ground. They're spreading the Roosters' defence. They're looking for a way through. North Adelaide looking to press. They've got to make it hard to get out of here. Oh, had the jumper held was back there in was Greg. But wasn't paid, actually was Wilkie. As McMahon took the mark and goes back in forward. Finds Hone. Hone now goes further afield to Battersby in open space. Now the switch back in, as Sturt liked to do, and finds Greenslade. Right on the corner of the centre square. Right half forward. Lead up. Oh, went straight over the top of Young. Safely marking by Georgie Thring. Everyone just stopped and look at him. So he spun around. Quick hands to Virgin. Got it now to James Craig. Big long kick. It's a 2-on-1. Tough. Oh, Tahana did well. Courageous. Met solidly by Jonas. Ball spills free. It was Guilfoyle. Now it comes out to Hone. Hone inside 50 over the top of Beard, and that mark safely taken by McDonough. Chance gone begging for the double blues. Steve Tahana courageous. Met full on by Rune Guilfoyle in that marking contest. Guilfoyle's probably come off second worst. It's now Grove for the Roosters. Long range kick. Ryswick taking the mark, paid. Fair enough too. Strong arms. Strong hands above his head. Lee Ryswick. So we ticked into time on right now. We're into the red zone. What can the red and white do? Kick now. Puts plenty of pressure on Swartz. It's stolen by Harms. Can they hurt him on the slingshot? Hand pass out wide for Battersby. No, there's a whistle gone. It's coming back. No, the mark's been paid. Player's confused. We're confused. But Crocker has the ball. He goes short and he finds Battersby. Defensive side of the scoreboard says we've gone 20 and a half minutes. There's not much time left. And the ball will go over the line and out of bounds. It's an 11-point margin. Two straight kicks. Wins it for North Adelaide. Probably another score. Locks it away for the double blues, who have the double chance riding on this. We know Adelaide had a percentage-boosting win up at the Riverland at Berry Oval. And they would get a sniff if Sturt dropped this one. But will they? Martin to Kirkwood. They've got ball in hand. They have the ascendancy. Kirkwood drives it inside 50. Good sport at the back from Patterson. Clever hands though. Greenslade got it out the back. Battersby to Martin. Martin lifted the eyes. He saw a lead. But it's a two-on-one situation. Carey was outnumbered. And George Thring did well. But it's going to come back because he's kicked it to one of the biggest men on the ground in Andre Perella. So Perella goes back, sends it back inside 50. Big fly from Patterson, couldn't take it. McDonough, front and square, did well. Linked up with Georgie Thring. Hand pass, good to Virgin. Gave it to McKenzie. They've got runners now. Tierley through the cricket pitch area. How's the kick to Harvey? Page has got to do well here. Maxi Thring's got it. He's got options up forward. He's got Ryswick. He's got 5 metres on his opponent. And Ryswick can go back. And if he can kick this, they're within 5 points. And within a straight kick of the lead. So Lee Ryswick, all the pressure sits on the shoulders of number 32. He's kicked one. He lines up. And you can hear the jeers because it's faded across the front of the goal face. Minor score, 10-point margin. Still two straight kicks in it. 10-9, 69, plays 12-7, 79. 22 and a quarter gone. Last quarter, McMahon goes for the short option. Safety to Crocker. Right back pocket, out of side. Time ticking away now. Time's the enemy for North Adelaide. It's not just the double blues. Stevens has it. High kick. Covers some good ground too. Flight the back there from Patterson. Front and square. Fall of the ball with Schwartz for North Adelaide. Wraps up Greenslade in the tackle. We'll have a ball up. Well, they'd need to make it happen pretty quickly here, North Adelaide. McKenzie now. Kirkwood. Make sure he's going nowhere. And we'll have another throw up. The time just ticking away. 23 minutes now. Gone on the clock. Perella. Craig. Perella got the better that time. Free kick. Going the way of North Adelaide, though. There was a jumper held. And Craig has it. What can the big man do? He knows time is of the essence. So he puts it high to Barnes. What can he do? Big pack of players. Motlop at the back. Releases the hand pass. Running onto it is Spinner. It's spinning ball. What can Spinner do? Oh, he's crashed into him in the back. The umpire didn't see it. Sturt get the ball out of trouble. De Leonardis is in there. It hasn't gone out yet. But Slimming makes sure it does. And we'll have a boundary throw in. Oh, the umpire just blindsided there. Spinner did well, put his body on the line. Throw in. Right in front of the bowling green. Coming up, 24 minutes gone. Minute by minute, the pressure builds. Perella, Barnes. Kick off the ground by Perella, if you don't mind. Sits for Shannon, puts his body over it. Finds Barnes, kick around the corner. Miracle goal won't happen, though. He's missed everything. Out of bounds on the full. It comes back now to Leanert. He just got it from the Matty Crocker kick. The free kick after Barnes. Desperate shot at goal. So Leanert there. Ball in hand. Drives it towards left halfback. Players set themselves. Oh, great mark, Beard. Been paid. One of the marks of the day. Great contested mark. Alex Barnes has taken a couple of rippers too. But that was a good pack contested mark. And Corey Beard in no rush. North have to press up. They have to commit, compete. George String does, punches it down. Hone for the double blues. Spinner stripped of it. Kirkwood now, who got it from Greenslade, slams it onto the boot. One-on-one contest, and great work back there by Patterson to just double punch it over the boundary line in front of Hansen, and we'll have a throw in. 25 gone. There wouldn't be much more time left. Unfortunately, it looks like for North Adelaide supporters, it was game, but not good enough. For Double Blues fans, you've got a top three chance going into September as Spinner runs away with the ball, kicks it towards the forward area for North Adelaide, picked up by De Leonardis, who kicks it to Motlop in a one-on-one. Clever out the back, and will it roll through? Oh, SDL, a Sam De Leonardis special. That was something magical. Little Sam. Well, he got the run of the green there. Motlop did well to just body it through and shepherd it through. It's a four-point ball game. 25 and three-quarter gone. De Leonardis kicks his first. Well, a quick tap away, a quick clearance here, and anything could happen. Everyone on the edge of their seat. We hope you're enjoying this at home. You'll be on the edge of yours. Pressure building, 26 gone, four-point margin. Craig with a big thump away, went past Shannon, picked up here by Crocker. The Double Blues keen to keep possession. Kirkwood kicks it out wide and finds the chest of Carey, and they'll slow it down. North Adelaide have to throw everything here. They're going backwards. The kick has to be good, and it is to Martin. One mistake here, and it will get burnt because North Adelaide are pressing up. Martin, he's got Guilfoy going backwards. He knows that's dangerous. Goes down the line, marks taken by Wilkie. There's a siren. Oh, heartbreak hotel for North Adelaide. Players drop to their knees. Disappointment, they are shattered. They came within a breath of one of the upsets of season 2016. But the Double Blues have escaped. They've escaped defeat. by the barest of margins, just 4 points at the end. Sturt 12-7, 79 have defeated North Adelaide 11-9, 75. 4 points in it. Desperately close, North Adelaide. They were desperate all day. They were defiant. They came home with a wet sail, but unfortunately were to be denied. The Double Blues celebrate. They've got the double chance now. North Adelaide finish on a fantastic note, albeit without the 2 points this afternoon. Let's go through your goal scorers. For the Double Blues, Mark Evans with four, Ben Hansen with two, and also Corey Beard with two. And singles to Greenslade, Kirkwood, McMahon and Crocker. For North Adelaide, well, multiple goal scorers there in Barnes, Clisby and Shannon, both with two each. And singles to Motlop, McDonough, DeLeonardis, Maxi Thring and Lee Ricewick. Crowd streaming onto the ground now to go and celebrate with their heroes for the Double Blues. For North Adelaide fans, well, it was game. As I said, they were terrific today, the Roosters. Hats off to them. They came here to play. They took it right up to one of the form sides of the competition, a side who strung 10 wins together at one stage of this year, and they just were denied by less than a straight kick. Let's have a look at some of your stats here in the game, just for the teams and then individuals. Then we'll quickly go around the grounds, thanks to Flight Centre, before we wrap it up here at Peter Motley Oval. Main stats winners, well, we'll have a look at the team first. Disposals, 308 North Adelaide, 357 Sturt. So they just had a little bit too much of the footy. 215 kicks to 180, the Double Blues, and 142 handballs to 128. 105 marks to 87. They just controlled the football a little bit more, and I think disposal by foot was the key factor in this game, as Josh Carr, well, Josh Carr doesn't have the troops there together, but they're out in the middle, all as one, having a chat with some of the senior players, Mitch Clisby out there as well. Keep going through some of these stats here as Sturt slowly come off the ground. The tackle count, well, it was very close, 70 to 68, so 138 tackles across the course of the day. As I said, the ice baths will get a workout tonight. Hit out 63 to 27, fantastic effort by James Craig. He came up against a couple of real good youngsters in Andre Perella and Lewis Young in his first game today. And young Lewis, well, he got a few lessons there, but he also held his own in his first game at league level. Some other major stats there. Looking at the inside 50s, 46 to 39 in favour of North Adelaide. They just burned it, unfortunately. Rebound 50s, 34 to 24. So the Sturt defence can probably stand up and take a lot of kudos for the win here today. Individual stats winners, we'll have a look at those players over 20 disposals for you to get a good feel of it. James Battersby was a game high 31 for the Double Blues. Brody Martin with 28. Zane Kirkwood with 28. So some familiar names there. And we talked about the centre clearance. Well, they are the clearance kings, the Double Blues. Jordy McKenzie, gallant effort, 28 disposals. Matty Crocker, 27. Jared Lean at 24. Marlon Motlop, 22 disposals. And also kicked a goal there as well. Marlon Motlop in that last quarter. Other players there to get in the 20s. Jack Stevens, 22. Roon Guilfoyle, 22 for the Double Blues. Tommy Schwartz, 21, and Mitch Clisby, 21 for the Roosters. We'll have a quick look around the grounds thanks to our friends at the Flight Centre. Give them a call on 131 600. Book a time to go into their centres. Have a chat with them about your next trip away. Show your SANFL membership and they'll knock $100 off the cost. We have final scores in two games so far. West Adelaide and Adelaide up in Berry earlier today. Adelaide 27-17, 179, defeating West Adelaide 13-7, 85. So a 94-point win there to the Crows. Here it was the Double Blues, 12-7, 79, defeating North Adelaide 11-9, 75. Game still in progress down at Mourne Team Hyundai Oval. Big win for the league leaders, Eagles, 21-11, 137. They hold a 73-point lead over Glenelg, 10-4, 64. And down at Alberton Oval, what a comeback by Norwood, but it won't be a comeback good enough. Port Adelaide running out, well, they lead there at the moment. Game still in progress, 15-7, 97. A 25-point lead over Norwood, 11-6, 72, who at one stage were 54 points down. So there's the scores, the stats, the wrap-up here this afternoon. Sturt running out winners. They got the 2 points there that they require to cement their double chance. That will take them up to 26 points and just out of reach of South Adelaide. So they'll still sit third as they leave the ground to the plaudits of their crowd. Their supporters be very happy with that. North Adelaide supporters very, very happy with their effort. We're very happy that we were able to bring you the game this afternoon. So on behalf of the SANFL live stream dream team, this is Don Cooper. I'd like to thank Steve on camera for giving us all the vision this afternoon and Adelaide AV for putting it all together. Hope you've enjoyed it.